वेलकम स्पीच।
थैंक यू श्रावणी, अ वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल। ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ द आर्ट एंड क्राफ्ट क्लब स्टूडेंट एक्टिविटी सेल ऑफ बैथुन कॉलेज, आई टेक द प्रिविलेज टू एक्सटेंड अ वेरी वार्म वेलकम टू आर एस्टीम्ड रिसोर्स पर्सन्स, आर बिलवड स्टूडेंट्स एंड द फैकल्टी मेंबर्स प्रेजेंट हियर। दिस ऑनलाइन वर्कशॉप हैज़ बीन ऑर्गेनाइज्ड बाई द मेंबर्स ऑफ आर्ट एंड क्राफ्ट क्लब, keeping in mind the necessity to take refuge to passion and creativity in order for our mental well-being during these distressful times. Pratyusha, it is wonderful to have you amidst us again, and we are looking forward to learn mixed media techniques from you. And Anubrata, we welcome you to the Bethune College fraternity. And again, we are looking forward to learn certain new techniques from you. So indeed, we are today blessed to have this enriching experience. And thank you all. Over to Shauni.
Thank you, ma'am. I would now like to introduce SB ma'am for the introduction of the student's activity cell. Please, SB ma'am, take it over. Ma'am. Didi, ma'am, ki aache?
Yes, ma'am is there, but I think she is facing some internet issues.
Okay. Please give us a moment.
Okay, Shauni, sorry, I was actually in another meeting. Two parallel meetings are going on, so I was a bit stuck up. I didn't hear that you requested me to formally welcome. So
yes, ma'am, no problem, ma'am.
For Pratyusha, there is no point of welcoming because she is ours. And Anubrata Moitro, I personally do not know you, but I'm sure that our students will be benefited. While you be sharing your knowledge and expertise, and I myself and I'm very interested about art and craft. So I think that it will be a very entertaining and enriching session. I welcome both of you to the workshop, and without wasting any more time, let us start what our students are waiting for. Okay?
Thank you, ma'am.
Keep going.
Good morning, everyone, professors, teachers, in charges, and my fellow mates. Welcome to the very first workshop of mixed media and sketching of the Art and Craft Club, Bethune College Students Committee. And I am Shauni Maldik, Head of Creative Affairs, Art and Craft Club. And I'm glad that we are all gathered here for something great, because I have this gut feeling, of course. And we have amongst ourselves our very own Miss Pratyusha Chakravarti, an ex-student of Bethune College who had graduated with BA English Honours in 2020. She is trained in traditional art and has also been working as an artist at the Share and Grow and Last Page Doodles since 2019. We also have Mr. Anubrata Moitro, who has graduated from Ananda Chandra College, Jalpaiguri, with BSc Computer Science Honours in 2020. He is self-taught and a freelancer. He has also been a portrait artist at Calcutta Spectrum since 2019. Having them here is an immense pleasure for all of us, and I hope you guys share something of great value from your wisdom pots, and looking forward towards it. All the best. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Shavani.
Hello, Shavani. Am I audible?
Yes, you are.
Yes, yes, absolutely.
Okay, so আমি স্ক্রিন শেয়ার করছি আমার নাম অনুব্রত মৈত্র আইল বি শোয়িং ইট ডাইরেক্টলি ফ্রম মাই ল্যাপটপ ওটাতে সুবিধা হবে সবার সো ইফ আই ক্যান জাস্ট শেয়ার দ্য স্ক্রিন ওকে শাওনি স্ক্রিন শেয়ারিংটা প্লিজ অন করে দে
জাস্ট আ মিনিট ওকে
ওকে ওকে
ম্যাম একটু কো-হোস্টিং রাইটসটা দিয়ে দিন আমাকে
যতক্ষণ আই এম গেটিং দ্যাট স্ক্রিন রেডি ওকে লেট মি জাস্ট শেয়ার হোয়াট উই উইল বি স্পিকিং অ্যাবাউট এবারে সাম গ্রাউন্ড রুলস আই ওয়ান্ট টু ফর্মালি ইন্ট্রোডিউস এখানে সবার চ্যাট ভয়েস যেহেতু মিউট আছে ক্যান এভরিবডি হিয়ার মি
ইয়েস ইয়েস উই ক্যান
ওকে সো যেহেতু এখানে সবার মিউট আছে তো আই উড রিকোয়েস্ট যদি কারো কোয়েশ্চেন্স থাকে চ্যাট অপশনসে গিয়ে ওকে আই গট দ্য কো-হোস্টিং অপশনস চ্যাট অপশনসে গিয়ে ইউ ক্যান পোস্ট ইয়োর কোয়েশ্চেন্স ইন ব্লক ক্যাপিটাল লেটার্স সো ওটা আমি দেখতে পারবো আফটার 15 মিনিটস অর সো সো লেট মি আই এম স্টিল নট সরি ওই আই এম জয়েন্ট ইন উইথ দ্য ল্যাপটপ তো give me that screen sharing option also that duto Anubrat Maitra ache
all right I'll do that the multiple participants can share simultaneously I think that will be feasible option
Yeah, out of the better way.
Yeah.
So, let's formally introduce anyway. Ami onek din theke drawing kori. Let's say choto theke, as in everybody does, I guess. So, okay. So, I'm a topic of, you know, practice mainly concerns realism. এবারে হোয়াট ইজ রিয়েলিজম হোয়াট ইজ আদার কাইন্ড অফ আর্ট ওটা নিয়ে পরে আসছি বাট আই মেইনলি ইউজ টু ড্র পোর্ট্রেটস লাইক আই এম ড্রয়িং পোর্ট্রেট সিন্স লাস্ট 5 ইয়ার্স অর সো তার আগে আমার ফর্মালি ড্রয়িং এর ইন্ট্রোডাকশনস আছে আই হ্যাভ ডান ওয়াটার কালার্স আই হ্যাভ ডান অয়েল প্যাস্টেলস যেরকম সানডে আর্ট টিউশনসে সবাইকে শেখানো হয় উইচ ফর্মস মাই বেস অফ ড্রয়িং So, we have to first recognize art is a subjective matter. Whatever I am going to show here, that might be good, like that might look good to many of you, or you might not, you know, agree with whatever I say. There is many roads to take. Ekta kono direct successor road nahi there is nothing of that sort that being said it does not matter ki whatever art books are written whatever knowledge I have gained through you know studying and practicing does not take value. Everybody's art session and their practice becomes a choice, and ultimately it forms a style. So we will go into style a bit. We will go into basics of drawing and how to think mainly. Because ami jodi ekhane kichu ekta dekhai, laptop er oi screen sharing option ta ekhon on nei.
We have added you as the co-host. Ekhono dekhachho na?
Na, arakta I guess. Like amar mobile e seta esche. I'm joining with the mobile jeta modhe amar screen dekhachhe. There is another Anubrata Moitra ota amar laptop theke connected ache.
Ota keo co-host.
Yeah, ওটাতে ওটাকে করে দাও।
হ্যাঁ, ওটাতেও করে দেওয়া আছে। আমাদের এখানে দেখাচ্ছে।
But I can't share screen.
এখন ট্রাই কর একবার।
করছি। It's not happening. Host disabled participant screen sharing. I
did know. All participants.
তুমি দুপুরে তোমাকে কোহোস্ট করা আছে। তুমি একটু ট্রাই করে দেখো।
হ্যাঁ, আমি করছি। আমার ল্যাপটপ থেকে হচ্ছে না। Probably আমার মোবাইল থেকে হবে। তো সেটা অফ করে ল্যাপটপটা দিলে বেটার হয়।
আচ্ছা, তো আমি তো বুঝতে পারছি না তোমার কোনটা ল্যাপটপ কোনটা মোবাইল। আমি
দুটোতেই করে দিই।
দুটোতেই করা আছে তোমার কি? তোমার দুটো অনুব্রত মৈত্র দুটো দুটো যে দুটো লগইন করেছো দুটোতেই করা আছে কিন্তু বহুত তোমার।
কিন্তু এখানে তো দেখতে পাচ্ছি।
আচ্ছা, ক্যান ইউ প্লিজ রিনেম ইওর ল্যাপটপ নেম সো দ্যাট উই ক্যান আন্ডারস্ট্যান্ড দ্যাট দ্যাটস দ্য ল্যাপটপ।
ওকে ওকে, ওয়েট, লেট মি সরি, এগুলো তো অনেক টাইম খাচ্ছে। ওকে, আমি রিনেম করেছি।
Yes.
Is it showing?
What have you renamed it to?
Anubrata Moitra _ laptop.
It's not updating itself on the participant list.
Yeah, it's not updating.
Is your laptop connected well to the internet? Is that an internet issue?
No. Karna ekhane ye dekhachhe.
Okay.
I can do everything. WhatsApp calls it in the background.
Ha ma'am, koreche. Ota problem noy.
See, ami laptop ta video ta on koreche, but ekhane issue dekhachhe.
Laptop video is not on yet.
Okay, let me just leave laptop theke and let me rejoin again.
Oh, but yeah.
Yes.
Okay. Please wait a bit, everybody.
Not an issue.
Let this happen.
Did the co-host korar ki mane shongkar kono upper limit ache?
Na ma'am, mone hoy na.
Ami ki ekbar ye kore abar co-host korbo ekbar.
Ma'am, apni leave korben na, apni thakun.
Leave korini, ami mane co-host korlam, mukhta off kore arekbar co-host korbo mane.
ম্যাম, উনি রিজয়েন করার চেষ্টা করছেন, তো আফটার হি রিজয়েন্স তখন আপনি করে দেবেন।
ইটস টেকিং আ লট অফ টাইম, বোধহয় আমার নেটওয়ার্ক ইস্যু।
আর ইউ কানেক্টেড অন দ্য সেম ইন্টারনেট ফ্রম টু ডিভাইসেস? দ্যাট ক্যান বি দ্য প্রবলেম।
ও ইয়েস,
সো দ্য ব্যান্ডউইথ ইজ গেটিং রিডিউসড।
ওকে ওকে ওকে, লেট মি শর্ট দিস আউট। আমি ভিডিওটা একটু স্টপ করছি।
Thank you.
Okay, I am joined in. I hope ठीक होगा. Yeah, I guess
you can share now.
I guess so. Wait, let me check. Yeah. Okay, am I sharing
yes.
now?
Yes, 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 yes,
yes. Okay, thank God. Acha. So this is my art style or whatever you might call it. But I'm just going to make an overview of what kind of drawings I do. These are digital paintings. But obviously these are taken from reference. And erokom ekta bird drawing er overview I'll be showing. These are some of my other works. I have done pencil drawings since long, so I have a pretty good idea about pencils. And that's basically it, right? Now, can everybody see this?
Yes.
Yes, we can.
Okay. So this is the reference photo that I have chosen. 8R drawing your approach, its method, and relating to other like. What should you be thinking while drawing? Because OTA becomes more important when you're trying to learn. Ami jodi ekhane ekta kichu kore dekhai, obviously it has taken me over 7 years to come to this point. It's not perfect. Karori perfect hoy na. We have to come with the fact the learning keeps on going. It does not stop. So I am at a position jekhane I come to learn about new things and I try to apply it in my drawings. So application of those things, knowing what I used to know, there may be some things that I might have done wrong previously, ekhon seta correct korar chesta kori. So this happens, it's a human nature. Ekhane ego side rekhe you have to continuously learn and be available to learning karon eta jodi na korte paro para jay tahole there is no point in drawing anything, right? We'll come back to that later. So if we are seeing this, right, everybody can see this.
Yes.
I'll be giving an overview of what happens in digital drawing as well, but prathame we need to learn some basic stuff. What happened with that yellow spot? Anyway, we are not considering that. First and foremost, I'll be using a round brush to do everything. And why is that so? I'll be telling it later. Shauni, you can ask, you know, you can see if there's some questions and ask me.
Yeah.
So I'm far. Looking. Okay. I'll be taking questions in a bit. So what we want to do right here, see, you can see the spots. It clear ashe, I guess. So our screen.
Yes, yes, yes.
Yeah, right. Okay, so basically we are going to plot out some points. এবার foremost আমি বলেছিলাম to keep an open mind about things what I am about to say. If you know everything or parts of things, because obviously আমরা এখন mature brain এর, everybody here is somewhat similar age এর আছে. So what happens is we can understand the basics and fundamentals of drawing itself. এবারে we know how drawing works. We are copying this drawing. But are we actually copying the drawing? We are not copying the drawing. Obviously, if somebody has hyperrealism as their subject, they might exactly copy the same things with the same proportions. But that is not my purpose. So we come to the first point, and that is purpose. Everything you start has a purpose. If we don't have a purpose, আমাদের ড্রয়িং করার ইন্টেন্ট সেম থিং অ্যাজ পারপাস ওটা আগে ফিগার আউট করতে লাগে রাইট নাও হোয়াট ইজ মাই ইন্টেনশন এখানে আমি ভিডিওটা যে দেখাবো হোয়াট ইজ মাই ইন্টেনশন ইটস স্টিল ভিজিবল Now, my intention is to study this entire drawing, photo, and to make it into a drawing, right? We have to understand that this is a bird. Obviously, it had a background, like a tree. So what are we focusing on? Now, whatever I say, we'll come back to this. I might digress a bit. But সব কিছু এটার মধ্যেই আসবে ওকে Okay, I need to minimize this. Okay, no problem. Let me just put this in the side. Put this in. Okay, so this is the drawing I made. Eta hocche photo. Okay. That's fine. Now we came here to talk about the purpose, right? Eta upore likhe rakhi. Now somebody's purpose might be hyperrealism, as I said. Kintu amar purpose ota na. I have come to study je kibhabe ekta bird drawing kaj kore. The bird has its head, body, tail. It has a specific structure. And flow. এবার এত কিছু এখনই জেনে লাভ নেই বিকজ উই ডোন্ট ওয়ান্ট দ্যাট সো দিস ইজ দ্য ফার্স্ট স্টেপ দ্যাট আই উইল ডু ওকে ইজ দিস ক্লিয়ারলি ভিজিবল
ইয়েস
জুম ইন Can you see the small lines?
Yes, yes, visible.
Shawni, just answer with the S. Yes, Talani, Bustavago, how is this going? Right.
Hello, I'm audible, right?
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay.
Okay. So the first time comes, যে আমরা এই ড্রয়িংটা বেসিক্স বেসিক শেপ অ্যান্ড ডাইরেকশনটা বুঝতে চাইছি ওকে সো দিস ইজ দ্য বেসিক শেপ অ্যান্ড ডাইরেকশন উই হ্যাভ দ্য আইস নোজ ইয়ার অ্যান্ড দিস ইজ আ ভেরি রফ ড্রয়িং এই রফ ড্রয়িং এর স্টেজ সাথে উই আর মেইনলি টকিং অ্যাবাউট প্রপোর্শন অ্যান্ড শেপস প্রপোর্শনস আর ভেরি ক্রুশিয়াল আমরা যদি প্রপোর্শনস আগে ঠিক মতন না করতে পারি তাহলে ইট বিকামস ভেরি ইউজলেস যে আমি এটাকে ফটো স্টাডি কেন করছি রাইট তো দ্য প্রপোর্শনস বিকাম আ ক্রুশিয়াল ফ্যাক্টর হ্যাভিং আ বিট অফ ট্রাবল ওকে This might take some while. Just okay. So we can log properly. Okay. So basically, we are talking about the proportion. But this is the first step. Jekhane, we have to get the drawing right. But in terms of the, we don't need. We don't need to do it perfectly. There is no perfection. Ekhane amader ota point na. Since I said amader purpose ta ki, we have to figure that out foremost. Amar purpose jodi etake directly. Okay. Please don't scratch that out. Ekhane everybody, like screen er moddhe. Yeah, sorry. So we have to find out that intention, the purpose. So amar purpose is. Figuring out the proportion ta kothay asche. If your purpose is drawing this, you know, like very neatly or you know, direct accurately with all the grid lines, yeah, you can do that. Obviously, there is no harm in doing that. Many people do that. Let it hang. Wait. Photoshop. Ecto problematic. Am I audible?
Yes.
But see.
Is it lagging again?
Yeah, it's lagging a bit. Sorry. So let it work. We'll be talking about mainly about the purpose. Secondly, we'll talk about the discipline. And thirdly, we'll talk about the process or the journey about what you need to think about while drawing this entire thing. Ekhane, the thought process is the main thing. This is not a very big deal. Eta ante you need a bit of time understanding. This understanding becomes very crucial if you want to draw something from a photo realistically. Why we want to do that, I'll come back to that later. But this is the first step. We got the basic shapes right. Then we come to the second step. Ekhane, the drawing becomes very clear, right? We got the outlines. Ekhane, we got the eyes, shapes. Everything is laid out in front of us to shade. Ebar shading er ager step ta is completely crucial because you cannot go outside this border line ebare ei jinish ta jodi na thake if you don't have this entire part okay the shading won't hold up there is no point in shading if you don't have the basic structure right okay so ekhane this part right here ekhane amader onek bit of time dite lage shading e beshi time dite lage na knowing how to draw becomes very crucial at this point jokhon ami kichu ekta copy korte chai and this is free hand to ekhane free hand jokhon ami copy korchi we have to look about all the nooks and crannies jetar moddhe line depth ache shape gulo change hocche right ebare what do I mean by line weight shapes proportions I'll give a choto overview see this bird right here has a spherical shaped head okay this is a spherical shaped head otar upore fur ache we understand that now this is where we come about understanding the photo obviously amra live drawing korchi na to amra photo theke dekhchi eta jodi amra na bujhte pari if you are thinking about you know this lines ekhane erokom ache the beak is here no we are not thinking about that we can't be thinking about that okay it's again lagging okay so what happens is we have to think about the spherical shape of the drawing and then the body and then the tail okay we have this covered in three parts right now let the lag go away a bit then I'll talk about more oh this is becoming a problem acha so till now do we have any questions I'll be taking questions if there is a lag or something like this
guys do you have any questions you can ask in the chat box
the lag is in there प्रचंड okay so we will be doing the proportion acha shetai ami bujhacchi je ami proportion ta bujhbo ki kore this is where it comes je if I okay so amar proportions ami kibhabe bujhbo right ekhane amar ekta drawing ache ekta board er photo ache so we have to recreate that we have to convert it into primary shapes এখানে শেপস শেপ ল্যাঙ্গুয়েজ যখন চলে আসে ইট ডুয়েলস ইনটু আ ভেরি বিগ পার্ট অফ দা আর্ট জার্নি কিন্তু প্রাইমারি শেপস বলতে আমরা বুঝি হচ্ছে সার্কেল স্কয়ার ট্রায়াঙ্গেল রেকট্যাঙ্গেল ইজ আ কাইন্ড অফ আ স্কয়ার এনিথিং গোস এবারে এটা 3D তে যদি আমি ভাবি দিস ইজ আ স্ফিয়ার উইথ আ শেডিং আ বিট অফ শেডিং দিস লুকস লাইক অ্যান এগ বাট এক্সকিউজ মি This is a cube, right? This is a cube, and this is a pyramid. If a pyramid ta cone hobe, eta structure ta kemon hobe, it does not matter. But we have to understand the 3D shape. Now, a shop kichu we will be trying on this bird. So let me turn down the opacity. It's still visible, right? Eta upore ami jodi draw kori. So the proportions are somewhat like ekhane ekta circle jetar upore fur ache this is a body which can be a circle or a cuboid and this is a triangle so since we are not doing this ami ekhane to trace korchi but we are not doing this. This is for understanding how to identify the shapes eta jodi amra na korte pari amader brain e then there is no point in drawing this at all because ekhane ami copy korar chesta korchi na I have to understand the overlying structure and the underlying shapes overlying er moddhe amar fur asche feathers asche details asche we are not going about that we are going to draw only the basic shapes right eta jodi thik proportion e chole ashe je ei ball ta koto tu এই কিউবয়েডটা কতটুকু এই ট্রায়াঙ্গেলটা কতটুকু ঠিক আছে এন্ড উই ক্যান গো ইন ডেপথ এন্ড কিপ অন রিডিউসিং দ্য এন্টায়ার থিং অ্যাজ শেপস রাইট নাও সি দিস ইজ আ বেসিক শেপ এন্ড ইট লুকস ভেরি আগলি ইট ডাজ লুক ভেরি আগলি তাই জন্য আই এম টকিং অ্যাবাউট দ্য পেন্সিল থিং ডিজিটাল কমস লেটার ডিজিটাল হোয়াইট কমস লেটার আই উইল বি টেলিং দ্যাট অ্যাট লিস্ট আমার আর্ট জার্নিতে ডিজিটাল আমি কিভাবে শিখেছি সেটা বলবো বাট তার আগে উই হ্যাভ টু আন্ডারস্ট্যান্ড দিস বেসিক থিংস অ্যান্ড হাউ টু হোল্ড আ পেন্সিল শেড অ্যান্ড দ্য রিয়েলিজম পার্ট যে আমি একটা ড্রয়িং যদি করি ইট শুড লুক লাইক আ বার্ড ওটার প্রপোর্শনটা ঠিক হবে ওটার স্কেচটা ঠিক হবে এভরিথিং শুড বি ইন দ্য রাইট প্লেস বিফোর আই স্টার্ট শেডিং ওকে সো back to where the drawing was this is the drawing
Anuprata, we have two other questions will you yeah. come back to that later
ask right now
can you please explain what is hyperrealism is it synonymous to mannerism
okay regarding questions like these I'll be coming to those later but eta kotha amar agei bola chilo the point of view where I'm coming from understanding hyperrealism and other forms of art google ja explanation dewa ache it's pretty straightforward when we are extremely going minute about the details of the drawing right that is their point of purpose as I said purpose is main what I'm trying to show here is my purpose and how you need to be good at that ebar eta hyperrealism e jay abstract e jay illustrations e jay and everything every underlying form of art has these fundamentals like ei jinish gulo if you are not understanding right now hyperrealism e giye you won't have fun at least I won't have fun ebar if I am understanding if I am decoding these all and otar upore ami jokhon চড়াচ্ছে একের পর এক লেয়ার দিস ইজ ওয়ার দ্য বার্ড কমস ইন টু লাইফ রাইট দ্য পয়েন্ট অফ হাইপাররিয়ালিজম আই দেয়ার অবভিয়াসলি সার্টেন দেয়ার আর সার্টেন পিপল হু এনজয় সার্টেন কাইন্ড অফ আর্ট Art is therapeutic. It's also subjective. We have to keep that in mind when we are looking at anybody's drawing, right? Now, if they are somewhat in a, you know, with experience, with 3-4 years under their belt, with just drawing and understanding basics, you can see the common errors not happening in their drawing anymore. Jeta ami bollam, in social media, we are used to seeing drawings which are very perfect with the reference photo they have done a study with all the grid lines and everything but I'm not here to teach that or do that I'm here to show my process and a process is some of the tips like this is like 7 years of whatever I know and whatever I should have known back then to otate amar onekta help hoto right now I could have improved a lot more so coming back to this drawing we understood shapes and then we are coming back to outline right then we understand ami jeta age bolechilam this is the shape right I know je ekhane ekta cuboid ache right I know ekhane ekta cuboid ache etar upore ki ashbe how is the chest protruding out this is what I want to show how are the wings laid upon the art entirely is a game of vocation with your mind like how much you speak with your mind depends upon you know how much you're interested in the drawing itself or what you want to study in the drawing as I said
na diye chhikhabo na tapore ami piti dari di tao ni ha ajbe actor
So, getting back to this, another proportion, we are figuring out the proportion right here. We are not thinking about shading. We are not thinking about anything other than the underlying shapes, structure, gesture, or flow. If a gesture or flow, kokhon ashe. I have not done this here because ekhane amar ota dorkar nei. But before coming back to this layer, amader ei je ekhane, ei je lines gulo ami verify already established korechi. Right? These things. This is the proportion. Etar upore kichu hobe na. The head must lie within this part, the body within this part, and the tail right here. It should end here. And this is the entire structure. এটার বাইরে আমার আমি যদি ডিটেলস ইনপুট করতে যাই আমি করতে পারি বাট দ্য বডি শুড নট বি বিগার দ্যান দিস পার্ট দ্য হেড শুড নট বি বিগার দ্যান দিস পার্ট দিস ইজ নট মাই পারপাস অফ দ্য স্টাডি এখানে আমি এখানে এটা ক্যারিকেচার করতে চাচ্ছি না অর এনিথিং আদার দ্যান জাস্ট স্টাডিং ইট অ্যাজ ইটস ওন বিকজ ইফ ইউ ডোন্ট ডু দ্যাট ইফ ইউ ডোন্ট নো হাউ ডাজন্ট রিয়েলি ম্যাটার আমি ক্যারিকেচার করতে পারবো কিনা বিকজ আই ডোন্ট নো ইন দ্য ফার্স্ট প্লেস কিভাবে আমার বডিটা লাই করছে And every other word is different. That's why the shape language comes into play. Every object has a shape language. Decoding those, okay? Decoding those into parts is where the game lies. This is the front plane. This is where the head lies with the spear. If I can show if it's a spear, right? If it's a sphere and there's a triangle because it's more or less flat. But the proportion of these, this is bigger, this is shorter, this is somewhat same. Eta amaderke age jante lagbe. Okay, and this only comes with experience and lots of drawing. You can't just say ji ami ekta drawing korlam and I can move on to something else. That's not the purpose here. We are trying to know. Now, why do we need to know? We'll come back to when I explain about digital drawing. But we come back to the part jekhane amar structure ta lain hoye geche. We know where to shade. We know the structure. We know where the feathers are. Ekhane ekta feather, the part of this, the tail, the basic things, right? Ekhane ekta feather ache, see? This part right here, the eye has somewhat like these shapes. Ekhane detailing ta kaj korche. Okay, it's lagging again. Do we have any other questions?
There is a very good question yes. in the chat box.
Okay.
And I think we intended to address it as well, Anubrata.
Okay.
She is asking, especially jokon pencil and paper e portrait korchi, grid use kora ki jaye and oneke tracing e help na, is that considered cheating?
Okay. Coming back to cheating and what form is cheating, okay, whatever I say, it's my personal opinion. Okay. Art is subjective, as I said. Ekhane oneke ekta dharona hote pare je na, it's not cheating. The only thing I consider cheating is onno karo drawing নিজের বলে চালানো উই হ্যাভ সিন ইট সো মেনি টাইমস ইন সোশ্যাল মিডিয়া দ্যাট ইট হ্যাজ বিকাম ইস্যু এভরিবডি নোজ অ্যান্ড এভরিবডি স্টিল ডাজ বাট উই শুড নট ডু দ্যাট ওনলি দ্যাট পার্ট ইজ চিটিং এবারে দ্য কামিং ব্যাক টু ট্রেসিং পার্ট ইয়া ইউ ক্যান ট্রেস অবভিয়াসলি ইউ ক্যান ট্রেস বাট হোয়াট ইজ ইউর পারপাস এভরিথিং লিডস ব্যাক টু পারপাস আমি এখানে কি দেখে কি করতে চাচ্ছি ইফ মাই পারপাস ইজ ট্রেসিং ওকে ওয়াই উড আই ট্রেস ওকে উই হ্যাভ টু আন্ডারস্ট্যান্ড কি জন্য আমরা ড্রয়িংটা করছি ফর মি ইট ইজ লাইক আমি শেডিংটা করতে চাই আমি ফ্রি হ্যান্ডেই করতে চাই আমি রিয়েলিজমে করতে চাই আমি পেন্সিল দিয়ে পুরোপুরি একটা পেপারে শেডিংটা করতে চাই আই ডোন্ট নিড ট্রেসিং পেপার ফর দ্যাট ওকে বাট ইফ ইউর পারপাস ইজ দ্য সেম And you are tracing it with a tracing paper. We are just skipping the entire shape design part, right? We are skipping the entire shape design part. Ami etokkhon jeta sphere er byapare bollam, cuboid er byapare bollam, deconstruction ta amra puro puri skip kore jacchi. So what is happening? You are learning only the shading maybe, but everything is interconnected. Everything is interconnected if you want to grow. right? Okay, that sounded a bit satisfying, I guess, regarding the tracing part, cheating part. The only art has no rules, right? Art has no rules. Somebody draws for happiness, somebody draws for, you know, fun. It's interrelated. Everything is, it's kind of the same. But what are we considering as cheating? Digital art is cheating, but what is cheating? What are we seeing? Like, if the artist has posted, right, a background, which is photo bashing, so we have to understand the purpose of background. Is it just for learning? Is it to improve his portfolio? Is it to bring more quantity to his, you know, number of, you know, creations? Because it's a creation in a way. But otar theke shudhu o jante pacche, right? We are not like je dekche she tar ekhane purpose ta fulfill hocche na, but who jeta korche je korche tar ekhane purpose ta ki ago fulfill hocche. Everything leads back to purpose. So before figuring out a drawing, we have to understand purpose. Okay, ebare we know ekhane amra ekta basically outline e chole eshi, right? The shape is here, ekhane wings ta jacche, this is the tail and this is the body. Now we will be coming to shading. This seems complicated. Okay, direct from this step to this step is a bit complicated, right? But we are going to deconstruct, specify and identify all the mistakes. Yeah, so we are keeping this aside. Let's keep it here. Shading, our main points, jodi ami discuss kori. Okay, we have, right now, we know the shape. Outline tar moddhei sob kichu hocche. That's why the basic proportion and doing the drawing, not loosely, or if you have done the drawing loosely, you know how the shapes will work. You want to make it very, superfluous thing, a very abstract thing, then it's fine. But I want to do it realistically. So this is how I will be going in my structure. Right. Okay, shading. The basic most important part you have to understand before shading is figuring out where the darkest part of the drawing lies. The darkest part, absolutely dark as you can get with a certain pencil. I have used a 6B pencil here. Okay, so this is how dark I could get, right? Now, what are the darkest part we are having? We are having this, and the beak is the darkest part, right? This is somewhat the darkest part. This is the darkest part. The you know, wings, these are the darkest part. The legs, and these are melting into the branch itself. So these are the darkest part. We have established that. Now, this I'm telling darkest part ta keno bolchi, because photo tar moddhe the darkest parts are these. But ekhane photo to photo determine korbe what color we are speaking about. Ekhane dark blue ache, black ache. The overlying color of the wings has blue in it, which is a dark shade in itself. So we have to figure out the shadow part, as in the darkest part. We are not thinking about the structure here, mind you. We are not thinking about the structure here. Kibhabe jinishta flow korche. We are just thinking about the darkest part. Amar eta darkest hobe, tail ta darkest hobe, and pa or branch ta darkest hobe. Anything other than that, it becomes a lighter portion. So we have to establish the darkest of the dark. So we have a bit of time constraint as in. Shauni, can you elaborate if there is something in the chat?
Yeah, there is. Can you elaborate on shading? You are getting to that part, right? And also, also there is just an announcement for all that considering the time constraint, we have scheduled for an interactive session at the end of each speaker's talk. So please keep sending all the questions in the chat box.
Okay. So we are coming back to shading, right? Shading, we have established the darkest part. Darkest dark. And this is crucial. This is where the point of contact or, you know, the viewer's eye will come into contact at the first moment they see the drawing, the darkest part of the drawings. It's very important. এখানে আমাদেরকে darkest partটা establish না করলে, we don't know আমাদের shading valueটা কোথায় গিয়ে দাঁড়াবে। আমরা কতটা light করব, আমরা কতটা dark করব। That is why people somewhat, you know, the common mistake people do is, আমরা light থেকে shade করা শুরু করি, which is fine. That's one approach as well. I'm not demeaning that, but my approach has the dark, establishing the darkest part at its core. Because amar ekhane purpose ta ki chilo, I'm making decisions while I'm drawing. I'm asking myself, je amar darkest part ta kothay hobe? We are simply not shading just for the sake of it, je ekhane dark ache, ekhane dark dilam tai. But amar ekhane dark dewa ki uchit? Ami ki etota dark korbo? আমি কি এতটা ডার্ক করলে অন্য পার্ট গুলো ঠিক থাকবে? সো উই আর এস্টাবলিশিং আ সার্টেন লিমিটেশনস অন আওয়ার সেলফ এন্ড উই হ্যাভ টু, ইউ নো, উই আর কনস্ট্রেইনিং আওয়ার সেলফ যে আমি এটা ডিসাইড করলে এটার উপরেই আমাকে কাজ করতে লাগবে। দ্যাটস হাউ উই আর ইম্প্রুভিং, উই আর নেমিং দ্য ডিসিশনস যে আমি এটার জন্য এটা করেছিলাম, তো নেক্সট ড্রয়িং এও লেট মি সি ইফ আই ক্যান, ইউ নো, ডু দ্য সেম থিংস অ্যান্ড দ্য রেজাল্ট কামস দ্য সেম ওয়ে। That's how we are doing. We are coming up to style. Okay, that would be at the end of it. So I hope you guys are understanding or, you know, taking a bit of tips, Jay, how to approach a photo study. Am jodi reference theke akche, what's the point of it? Ami jeta bollam, purpose. If your purpose is stylization, then you can do everything. But tar age amake basic proportions ta jante lagbe. How do I stylize if I don't know, you know, how a bird really looks? It can't be just like goal, arakta goal, and there's a tail, and there's a beak, and there's an eye. That's bullshit, right? We are not doing that. We want to know how it looks good. Okay, so this is why photo study or, you know, draw from reference. Accumulating this on a big scale lets you understand the basics of everything, light and shadow, in its core part. This is the darkest dark. Now, in pencils, darkest dark ta ami ekhane korechi. See, I'm zooming in. This is not as dark as this portion. Okay, this is the darkest portion. This is the darkest portion. Right, the bird's feet, the wings, and the eyes. These are the darkest portions. Other than this, egla je shading korechi, these comes into half tones. Okay, we will be coming to half tones. You know, darkest dark to half tones, right? These are half tones. Half tones are basically the point where the light is interacting with the structure, but it's not entirely going into the shadow part. Okay, so these are the half tones. This right here, this, you know, where the shading is fading away. Simply put, the shading is fading away into the light area, That's why we have to understand and establish the darkest dark at first. তখনই আমরা লাইট পোর্শনের দিকে এগোচ্ছি বিকজ দ্য পেপার ইটসেলফ ইজ হোয়াইট সো উই নো দ্য ডার্ক দ্য লাইটেস্ট ইউ নো দ্য ভ্যালু ইজ দ্য পেপার ইটসেলফ সি দ্যাটস প্রিটি কমন সেন্স সো উই হ্যাভ টু এস্টাবলিশ দ্য ডার্ক 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 পার্টস অ্যাট ফার্স্ট সো উই হ্যাভ এস্টাবলিশ দ্যাট নাও ওয়াই আই হ্যাভ শেডেড দ্য ব্রাঞ্চ লাইক দিস অ্যান্ড ইউ নো ইটস ফেডিং অ্যাওয়ে বিকজ ইটস নট ফেডিং অ্যাওয়ে হিয়ার right I have just made it like fading away here keno koreche seta I'll be coming back to the third area ami proportions niye kotha bolchi shading niye kotha bollam and then I'll be coming back to contrast which is the last part of the drawing there is the dark parts and the half tones our drawing is coming to kind of like it seems similar now এখানে একটু এক্সপিরিয়েন্স এর কথা বলতে পারি দ্য আই এন্ড ইটস আ ভেরি লো রেজলিউশন ড্রয়িং ফটো রাইট সো দ্য আই হ্যাজ আ হাই লাইট ইউ নো দ্য লাইট রাইট হিয়ার সি ইউ ক্যান সি রাইট হিয়ার ইটস আ বিট অফ লাইট আই ডোন্ট নো ইফ ইউ ক্যান সি বাট ইট ডাজ নট ইয়া But it does not really make sense. Like, why would I make the eye totally dark? Amar shekhane attraction ta ashe na, at least I don't feel like it. You may, it's subjective, obviously. Now, that's why I have put a bit of iris, like in the human eye. So it takes a bit of attention, okay? A bit, like slight bit of attention with the highlight and the lesser shadow. This is entirely your choice, your decision. This is where you are coming into play. We are not just blindly photocopying the entire thing. We are thinking about it. You're thinking to yourself, ja ami eta kibhabe aro attractive korte pari. Making a drawing at each step look beautiful is also a purpose, is also my purpose. That's why ami ei photo study ta korchi. I have figured out je ami ei step e korbo so that it looks pleasing it's a the entire art medium is a visual skill we have to keep in mind to make things look beautiful ever what do I mean by beautiful it's also subjective does a monster does not look beautiful does a you know a frog a very ugly frog can we not make it look beautiful we can but a beautiful ta kotha theke ashbe that's where again proportions come into play shapes come into play and shape language design theory comes into play a bit of design theory if I'm playing like if I'm talking about this I mean design theory jodi apply kori ekhane the main the most important like you can write it down the most important design theory is including big big right medium and small these shapes must be in your drawing to make it look pleasing now I cannot emphasize on this you can literally take any photo any drawing from you know established artists freelancers people who have experience have studied drawing they will tell you that there is big medium small coming into play right so what's my big medium small here jodi ami direct at 1.8 eta dekhi the biggest portion is the body the smallest portion like okay the medium portion is kind of the tail see it's not the entire body it's the tail and the smallest is the eye detail it's not the head it's the eye detail okay I rubbed that off accidentally. Right. So we have come into the darkest dark and the half tones. We cleared this part. Okay. This side, half tones and darkest dark. Right. Now we are coming into this portion. Okay. What is the difference? It again, see the darkest dark. okay, then we are underlying the other parts of the half tones, you know, where it's not the lightest light. Okay. Now, the darkest dark and the lightest light are the two areas of your shading, like the extreme points. If we have a, you know, a value scale, so this will be entire like black, right? This will be entire black, and this is the lightest part. And if I have to choose a color, right, if I choose gray, then this is the gray area. Okay. The portion where it's not the darkest dark, but not the lightest light. Now we have to, again, purpose to define kore, lightest light designer mulda ante lagbe. What is my lightest light? Say I'm leaving out, even I have rubbed out a part of the head. Okay, these are like small things you have to keep in mind while, like, we are not drawing blindly. Like, I cannot emphasize on this fact, we are not drawing blindly. We are drawing freehand. We are not drawing with grids. We are thinking. And it's very crucial, because actor upore jodi we can apply these, we can apply it to the thousand other works that we will be doing in future. This is where improvement comes. And maybe people have different, you know, approach, but it's always nice to keep an open mind about other people's approach as well. So this is my approach. You can take some of these tips, you know, apply in your drawings, whatever it might be. Like, I'm not talking about only realistic shading here. To illustration korte paris, anybody can do any sort of art, even abstract art. Abstract art should have an hierarchy of the value structure, lightest light, darkest dark, and the half tones. We have to understand that. That is what makes it visually pleasing. Okay. So we are coming back to this, we can see the difference it makes just by adding the half tones. You know, it's not entirely the half tones, because ekhane amar shading er modhe details ashche, right? I did not talk about details right now, but this is the stage where we are thinking about details. This was the stage where we are thinking about the darkest dark and its shape. Okay, see, this right here is a shape. Okay, let me choose a bright one. This right here is a shape, right? Okay, triangular shape. This is a shape. This is a shape. We are deconstructing. The entire game lies in deconstruction again and again and again, till the point where you know that this is what I like the most. You have to be decisive on the part. Okay, so coming back to a point, he does these things take all the fun away? For me, it doesn't really. I like to do these kind of things, talk to myself in the head. But if it's taking fun away from you, this is where we have to understand that we are lacking skills. We are lacking skills because we don't understand. Like, I mean, I can shape it. I can just see this and I can just go like this with my pencils, right? This is what I was doing before, what most people do. But if I establish, you know, in my mind, I can act a shape, this turns, this has a shape, definite structure. This is where my shading will be. That is where you know that you are not going wrong. This is your creation. This is how you're making it part of your creation. It's not just a photo study right now, because you are taking it on your own. You're establishing values. This is nothing is just copied, because you have established all the details. You know how the things are going to work. And ekhane, acha, still we are in the darkest part, right? Okay, we are going into the details. If a detail say ami ki ki kothay focus korbo, right? My focal areas of details should be, okay, I'm zooming in, this part, see, it has details. This part, it has details. You know, this part, it has details. This entire region, it has details. This part, it does not have details that much. right? This part, it may be, it's a hard edge, you know, like ekhane ekta literally khub hard edge ache, we can see that and we can include in our details, but it's not really important. Jeta ami pore ashi, but we are establishing all the values step by step. This is the second last step where we have established the details, where we will be establishing the details and the you know, the other part of the shading, which is not entirely, you know, white. This is entirely white, this area entirely white, this is entirely white, this is entirely white. We are like excluding all the white parts and shading accurately, trying to emulate the details wherever it is. See, details, 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 right? Details. Okay, now many people might ask, jay, hyperrealism is all about details, right? We ekhane onek jaygay the details nei, tai jonno ami ekhane details korchi na. And I can say yes, ami dekhe korchi details ta. Hyperrealism, if it's all about details, but you have to make that details look good, right? We come back to the first part, proportions. You know, the shape ta jodi thik na thake otar upore details diye labh nai. You cannot hold a bird together just with feathers. You have to know the body, the tail, the wings, the eyes, the beak, and everything where it is standing, just like the photo. We are emulating the photo. So ekhane ami jodi age theke details dewa shuru kori, and if I even think about details, we are not coming to this field. See, ekhane ami details er kotha bhabchi na, but I am just taking pencil strokes. I have to mark my pencil strokes on the darkest part. This is what I am keeping in mind, right? Ekhane I am talking about details. Ekhane ami ekta details korbo. See, this is the detail part and this is the detail part. Ekhane ami rubber use korechi, very ami mechanical pencil use korechi, and is dutu pencil lage ekhane kaaj kore.
You got muted somehow. You're audible.
Okay, I'm audible, right? Sorry about that. I saw a question, how to make the details precise. We don't want precise. We don't want precision. We want details as it is showing. See, this part right here, it does not match with this. It does not. It somewhat matches, but it does not entirely match. And I don't have to do that. That is not my purpose. My purpose is showing the details on these part, just showing it. Like ekhane amar feather ta turn korche. So this is where studying the, you know, really studying the reference photo comes into play. Ekhane feather ta turn korche, ekhane feather ache, ekhane feather ta erokom, you know, and this is a, you know, a butt area with, you know, bird butt, I guess, and this is where the tail forms. So this is casting a shadow ekhane, and there are many feathers. Kintu amar ota jay ashe na, because I can just show it with, you know, pencil line, just erokom. These are literally pencil lines, and you will be good at these pencil lines with experience, with, you know, drawing that outline. You have to draw that outline. Outline ta jodi ami thik moto na korte pari, ami ekhane pencil lines dite parbo. There is no point. Everything is connected, as I said. Ami outline ta jodi thik moto na korte pari, ami shading kibhabe korbo eigula. Makes sense, right? To someone might ask, no, I don't want to do only outlines. I want to shade as well, and I want to be this good, or, you know, somewhat good, as in whatever this is. So you cannot. Okay, it takes time. If our to that point, like, the purpose of your drawing comes again into factor, because ami jokhon, when you're learning, you obviously don't know the entire part. Ami shading part of the mane ami jodi na jani shading tahole ami shading part of the jete parbo na. So that means, won't I do shading? Obviously, I will. I will. I will do shading anyway. And it will be a mistake. It will be horrible. And that is how you learn. This is where the learning curve comes. Acha. Taking this entire thing. Okay, it's coming to... Just put it. Whatever we are doing here, right? See, I have erased some of the parts where the outline was. Those are my lightest part. This area, see, I have erased that. Why have I erased that? Everything has a decision. Everything has a decision, and I cannot emphasize that enough. You have to decide. Otherwise, you're not learning anything. You have to decide, even if it's a mistake. Next drawing will be better. You have to keep this in mind if you want to improve, obviously. If you don't, if you just, you know, you're drawing for fun, I just want to draw this, then you can do whatever. But you won't improve in 5 years of time. Right? So this is where the detailing is coming. I told you the precisions. I don't need precision. I just need some details. I said the feathers are going in some direction. So we are just following that direction. See here. Okay, I'll come back to that later. I'll just tell you. Okay, this is the part where it's kind of complete. But does it look complete? Okay, this is where the last part of, you know, the entire, what is that? Shiny, what is the time? How much did I speak? And how much did I cover?
It's 12:17 right now. I guess okay. You should, yeah, be a bit quick, I guess.
Yeah. This is where we are talking about the last part of the drawing, to how to make it more nice. Now, this is where many of, I'm rubbing out the shading part. We don't need this anymore. We have established the darkest dark, the half tones, and the details. This is not just like, you know, every artist does it in their own way. You have to figure out what process do you want to get into to make it like, you know, you're improving, you're deciding. This is the deciding factor. Now, where do I want to look when I'm seeing the drawing for the first time? This is where the reference does not make sense anymore. Okay, this is only the drawing right now. I don't want to see the reference anymore. Why do I not want to see the reference anymore? Because if you are just, you know, this is a blank screen and suddenly this popped up. What's the point of detail? What's my point of interest? Most people would be looking, including myself, would be looking at this area. Right? This is where the darkest dark is. And, you know, this is where much of the detailing lies. And, you know, it's well executed at this point. But I don't want that. I want the face to be highlighted. I want this face to be highlighted. Okay. I don't want this to come across, you know, as in like the main focus point. Focal point is a very important thing here. Focal point. Focal point. As I said, we are not talking about reference. This is where, you know, some of the tips, you'll come across this when you're drawing many drawings. It's just not one and two drawings, it's just many drawings. Okay. So the focal point is right now here with all the darkest area, the detailings and everything. But then I shade the background. I have shaded the background, right? Yeah, sorry. From this, we go to this. I've shaded the background. So what happens? Now when you're looking at this thing, right from, you know, a blank screen, and then say about in a social media, you're just scrolling, and then you see this drawing. What is the point of interest that you're getting? You know, the brightest point of the drawing. What is it right now? This. this is the brightest point. This is where my focal lies. Okay, this is where my focal lies. How did I do it? I just shaded the background so that the edges, you know, are well defined. Little crooks and crannies, these are the detailings. You know, you have to learn it like pencil, like lines. This is entirely made of lines. Okay. This is the shading part. This is the white area. See, now, what more did I change? This is a massive change that is happening right here. But from here to this point, we have changed a lot. After shading this point, this part, I need another focal point. It's a good practice to have two to three focal points in your drawing. Just one focal point doesn't, you know, serve the purpose. So it has to be the face. And, you know, we made so much, you know, like decisions, right? You know, doing this part. So why doesn't this be a focal point as well? The darkest part of the drawing. Now, I just made it a darkest part. It wasn't the darkest part here. See, it wasn't the darkest part here. I made it again. Like, just drop the pencil. So you're making the darkest part. You want the darkest part to be there. This is your decision. It's not like reference aache kiota. I don't know. I don't care. I don't care about the reference anymore. I just want this to be a good drawing in itself. And then I've already said the darkest part is here. So how dark do I do the background? Do I make it entirely black? No, because the darkest part is still here. We have to keep that. I want to keep that. So we make it just light enough, you know, just light enough so that this part is so very much highlighted. Okay, secondly, I told the focal points, you know, points because one, two. Secondly, what is that? Contrast. Photoshop lags a lot, so be patient. Contrast. What do I mean by contrast? You know, it goes back to the same thing, making decision about the darkest dark, darkest lightest light. If we have made that clear, contrast isn't much of an issue right now. It's not much of an issue. What am I doing for the contrast to make it look a bit good? I want this focal point to be here. I have blurred this out. Why did I blur this part out? Because there is a very dark portion of the beak right now. I don't want it to contrast with the head directly. I want it blurred. Okay. I want this part to be blurred. It wasn't. There is a hard shape here, but I want it blurred. That is where the contrast is happening. You know, hard edge. You know, there are many hard edges. You know, this hard edge, soft edge, soft edge. But these are dark. See, if I'm focusing here, these are light, these are dark. These part. It wasn't. I made it dark later after I added the background. Similarly, this point is blurred out. Okay. Now, how do I actually shade the background? This comes again with experience and trial and error. There are many drawings I can say which just has been ruined just by adding the background. Okay. It just made no sense. And those were my mistakes. You have to learn from your mistakes a lot. A basic, you know, fundamental of blurring and hard edge, soft edge is wherever there is a light part, you know, it basically comes in contrast. You don't need a number three for that. See, this is the lightest part and there is a dark part. So we'll just make the hard edge very clear right now. Also, what was my focal point? Here. So I am not shade. I'm not very curious about the shading here. This part cannot be as light as this part. Even though you can see ekhane onekta light areas ache. Like this light area is equivalent to this. But we are not doing that. I don't want that. Okay, it just stopped. So yeah, it's dropped. So are there any questions? Okay, it's working again. Shauni, is there any question? So I'll jump into the pen.
Not yet.
Okay, so we have done focal points, contrast, and this is where our pencil drawing comes to an end. Okay, this is where the pencil drawing comes to an end. So did I draw it, without saying? Obviously not, but we made a lot of sense to the drawing right here. This is something you can apply anywhere, be it portraits. Portraits are, advanced topics. And you have to understand, there is one thing I need to say before I go into, pen drawing, is recognition. Recognize. What do I need to recognize? My mistakes, obviously, and skill. In which skill level you are. Obviously, is this the best drawing in the world? Not by far. So many people can do it. I hope, most people watching this can do this, but this can be better. I want to be better. I want to be better with my shading. So I need to emphasize on my skill. If you cannot do that, proportional part right, for me, the shading comes later. So this won't hold up, because as you can see, it all comes down to from this portion to directly in the last. There is hardly any change in the drawing. See, the shape is intact. It's only the shading part, the blurring out. These doesn't matter. But the entire portion, this thing, is intact, and that is where you have to start. Okay, what was I saying? Skill. Okay, and then self-critic. Nobody else can teach you art. I cannot teach you art. Nobody can teach you art. No teacher in the world can teach you art. It is just recognizing your skill level and what you are liking to do. Right? Okay. Now, what do I mean by, you cannot, nobody can teach you art? So what am I talking about? All these tips, what does it matter? It does not. It literally does not matter to somebody who will not be drawing like this. But if you want to draw like this, if you want to, point these out, then you can. You can. And then these are the tips you have to keep in mind. Talk to yourself and then draw the entire part. It's just not seeing and drawing. It's so many things coming into play. Right. Okay. Pencil part, we are coming to a close. If you can, have a good grab of this part, the shading, half tones, light tones, and you have made all the decisions. Decisions are crucial. You have made all the decision about the darkest part to be here, the eye part to be here, everything. The decision is absolute. You don't want things to change. Then we go into the pen drawing. Right? I'll talk about the reference right now. But see, the pencil drawing and the pen drawing, there are much differences. Firstly, I did it freehand. I did it second time. So obviously, it won't be a Xerox copy. I obviously want to improve on things. So whatever I said here about the details, your shadow areas and point of interest, contrast, everything comes into play, and in a hard, bold line, because pen drawing a white and black chara kichu nahi. Acha, saying this is not ballpoint pen, this is Faber-Castell Pitt Artist fine liners. I'm using these for my pen drawings because it gives me a uniform black line. It gives me a uniform black line that a ball pen hardly power jai. Ball pen is good for shading, to be honest. It's not really good for drawing like these, where you are putting lines in and out everywhere. It's all lines. Okay, so how did I come back to this? Now, as I said, the purpose. Something is happening right now. My purpose has changed, right? My purpose has changed. How has it changed? I want to make the bird look a bit more cuter. It's kind of obvious. The bird is a very cute subject. I wanted to make it look cuter than the reference picture. I literally don't have to see the reference picture right now. I can just, you know, off it. I can just see my pencil drawing back and forth and make the pen drawing as well. Somebody put a red mark. So yeah, what do I want to make it look like? I will be very brief here. See, I talked about proportion. I have messed around with the proportion of the head here. I wanted to make it look a bit fluffier. What will I do? I will make the body squishy. How do you squish? It's basically, you know, shape manipulation. That will be going in your head. And that is the first part. If you remember, I said that is the first part of the drawing. You know, what is your purpose? Shapes and proportion has to be correct. If you can do that properly, this is, you know, as easy as doing anything else. So I have made the face a bit bigger, the body a bit shorter. That's all I'm doing with the stylization. You know, caricature goes a long way of doing many things to these, but being brief, this is the decision that I have taken, you know, just to make it look that I'm still doing a photocopy kind of a thing from this reference. Now you can see, I'll be coming back to the bare bones. Same thing as in the pencil, the dark is dark. These lines are not like making, say I've made pencil lines, but those are scratches, see here, here. Those are like figuring out what my boundaries are. Okay, you get good by only studying and figuring out how this is working. That's how you will be quick to recognize amar proportion ekhane, amar proportion ekhane. It will come as in like this, see this is a straight thing. This is not as parallel as that. And this is where the bird body lies. You will be able to do these with a bit of practice. Now these are the darkest areas. Very dark areas, okay? We don't have, you know, these are like basic shapes. Like what is determining these shapes? I am just determining these shapes. These shapes can be anything. But to keep in mind, as I said, I know the direction of feathers is here. Okay, see, here. Then it's here. It's here, right? And then somewhat like this shape. These are the directions, somewhat here. Okay, you have to think about these very much. The direction of the wing is very straightforward. It's just like this, and it's just like this, right? It's straightforward. Everybody can do this. Now I'm showing it like this in a digital medium. What people can do is just trace. Just put a tracing paper on top of your, you know, printed reference drawing. And do these kind of things with the marker. Just do it. You will see that, you know, when you'll be removing the tracing, when you'll be removing the tracing paper, you will see there is so much to learn from that. The proportions are right, everything is right. Then you can move on to the next part. But doing it without the tracing paper is your motive. Okay. Everything is easy in digital art, right? But if you take away everything, then should I not be able to draw? I will be able to draw with anything I have. Maybe it won't look like this, but it will still be beautiful. Like somewhat, you know, at least I will be proud of that. Does that mean it doesn't have mistakes? It will have a lots of mistake. I have to rectify it in the next time. So we won't think about that. Now, the darkest area, and then, you know, what happens here is I'm using, it comes with a, you know, four pen tips. Okay. So the blackest area I have done with a brush pen. I'll just show it. I know most of you already know, but this is a brush pen. See, it has a tip like a brush, somewhat a sketch pen type. And there are others, like the fine liner part, the smallest is 0.3. And this is important. I'm not saying it like this because you need to know the thickness. You need to design as well. Ekhane decision ta crucial. These lines are equal in size. So this is made with a 0.3. Some of these lines are made with a thicker pen. So you have to decide what you want to do, where is your point of contrast and everything else. Now, seeing at this, we know that it's a kind of a complete drawing. I can leave it here. But again, I will just turn off the reference and then repeat to myself, what does my focal point look like? Now here, obviously I've put much time doing this. So I want the focal point to be this. But I don't want to be directly like this is the primary focal point. Okay. And this will be a secondary focal point. What will I do for that? I will put darker boundaries. Very simple. Just darker boundaries. See, line, but I just made it a bit darker. See, where to put darker boundaries is where forms come into play, structure comes into play. We know that the direction is here, okay? And the chest area is outward, so it's here. It will be lighter because the light is hitting directly here. This is a graphical element. It's not realistic. A bird won't have feathers which are so, shape defined, like, Dragon Ball Z type characters. There is so much of, like I have just grouped feathers, right? And this is a design element. You want graphic shapes. You don't want feathers. You want graphic shapes. These are not feathers. These are just lines. Lines put in different directions. This is a shape. This is a shape. Everything right here is a shape. Okay, so this is where I'll kind of finish. It's already, I guess, 12:30. Yeah, 12:37, I'll just complete it. Shauni, just.
Yes, I have one question. That is, you have used different types of line strokes here.
Yes.
Right. So, মানে নিজের আন্দাজেই করেছো না ইউ হ্যাভ ফলোড দ্য ড্রয়িং মানে দ্য রেফারেন্স পিকচার
হোয়াট ডিড আই সে দ্য রেফারেন্স পিকচার ডাজ নট হ্যাভ এনি লাইন্স লাইক ইট জাস্ট ফেদারস ইয়েস ইট হ্যাজ ডাইরেকশনস অফ লাইন্স অ্যাজ লাইক জাস্ট ওয়েট ওয়েট সি লেট মি এক্সপ্লেইন ওয়াও এনিওয়ে ইফ ইউ ক্যান সি দিস এরিয়া দেয়ার আর ফেদারস. Right? I don't want to make feathers. It will be very time consuming. I don't want to do that. This is done in like one hour, I guess, this pen drawing. I want to be fast. It should have expression. So what do I need to do? I can make dark lines out there. What is my direction? It's still lagging. Sorry. Lack quotes. What I'm thinking about is the direction of the feather lines. See, if I can make the directions look somewhat similar to the reference picture itself, it emulates feather. It emulates. I don't have to draw feathers. I have to draw shapes. See, this is a shape. Okay. These are not lines. These are not just like, I put like this, I put like this. Like, it's not, I have to group it all together. This is where design theory comes into play and your practice. Okay, this is how you improve. And right from the beginning, what I'm talking about, structure, I did not go deep into that because it takes a lot of while to speak about these things. If I have to show a proper drawing come to an end, it takes a long time. But what I'm trying to figure out here is what are your focal points are. And how are you solving a puzzle? This is a puzzle. Okay, I treat every photo reference that I take as a puzzle. I'm just not blindly copying it like this. The head is not similar. You know, the eyes are not similar. Why did I make the eyes like this? Why is there a white dot right here? Why? Because I want it there. This is where the viewer's attention comes into play. And you have to constantly think this. Constantly. There is no shortcuts. Constantly think. And you get a bit faster day by day.
Okay, thank you. And we have another question by Debushmita.
Yes.
And she's asking, my question is a bit off topic, but I struggle when it comes to drawing a particular person's portrait. Can you give us some tips to make the portrait look more like the person and not his or her relative? How to understand the features that makes a person him or her to enhance it?
This is really advanced topic. Portraiture, I take it as a very advanced topic. Very advanced. Whatever I have said here, if you cannot do these things, if you cannot come to this point, I'm pointing out my mistake. What's happening, since there's a freehand drawing, the shape, this is more crooked. This is not. And that is my mistake. This is what happens when you're drawing freehand. Coming back to portraiture, this is what will happen when you're drawing portraiture as well. I don't want to dwell deep into it because it will take a bit of time. But similarly, when I said deconstructing every part of the picture is where your answer lies. Like even in the smallest part, I am deconstructing this more and more, but let me deconstruct only the face. Okay, how do I make that? Because the face looks similar, right? The face looks similar. Portraiture is just advanced of this. How do I make the shape look similar? This is a semicircle. This is an inverted semicircle. Burger. And there is a triangle. But the triangle is crooked. See, the triangle is crooked. So when you're drawing, you have to draw a crooked triangle like this, not just like this. There is a difference. See, subtle difference. It's very subtle difference. Like this triangle is similar to this, but this triangle is not. The angle is different. If you don't understand this, portraiture needs a bit of time. You don't have to make portraits as well. You don't have to just come into direct shading of the portraiture. I follow these few steps right from the beginning. This part, or even say this part, is where everything is there. Everything, from especially in portraiture. If you cannot do a portraiture with pencils, obviously, you don't have structure. You don't know where the line will curve, the nose will be, setting about. You have to trace it. I did not. Okay. But you can. It's not cheating. It's learning faster. If somebody just hammered into my brain that there is no cheating, like tracing, the only cheating would be saying somebody else's drawing as your own. You can obviously, I'm not saying this is my, creation or something. I have just done a photo study. So that's the only cheating part I consider as, really cheating. If you want to improve, trace everything that you have. Trace every picture, trace every eye, and then when you've completed tracing, see, this is semicircle, and there is a small, but this circle is not here, it's not here, it's right, not even in the middle. See, it's right here. You have to think about these shape things. Now, when you're thinking, you can trace this, no problem at all, just trace it. But don't post in Instagram showing I have done this so and so. Just be honest with yourself. You are tracing this, this is also a bulging out part. This, trace it. And when you look at it, the tracing paper, this is what it comes to look like. But then you have to make it look like this. that is where the struggle comes. And you have to constantly think, what am I doing wrong? How can I improve? Where are the angles? It's a deep entire conversation. It takes very long. I won't like say a portrait, you know, you can do an expressive portrait in just 15 minutes. It takes years to do a proper portrait. I can do a bird like this, say, you know, it's a bird somewhat.
The video is gone. Anubrata?
I guess he's having some network issues.
Can you hear us? Phone died. Okay. Can you come online from the laptop? Okay then.
Okay then, Pratushadi. Please take it over from here. Sorry that Anubrata Das session ended so abruptly. So Pratushadi, we are so glad to have you here. Please take it over.
Hey everyone. I think I won't delay anymore and I'll just get straight to the point. So I am here to discuss about watercolor and some other mediums of painting. I have some videos of me painting because I figured that doing it live in front of a laptop and device and all, because I am a very messy person, it can get messy. So I just thought I thought it safe to record myself and then show you by sharing my screen. So I'll be doing that. We don't have much time, so I'll just get straight to the point. Anubrata, you need to stop sharing the screen. Yes. Anubrata, if you're still there. I think he stopped. Did he stop? So yeah, I have some videos that I want to show you. Can you see the screen? Guys, can you see the screen?
Yes, the screen is with me.
Okay. So see, I have some videos of me painting florals, mountains and some clouds. I will like to begin with the florals. So let's see then. Yeah, can you see it?
Not yet. Floral click hoya ache, but ekhono kichu play hoyni. Did you play it? Okay.
No, I don't think so. Wait, then I will have to share my VLC. Okay. Wait. Just wait a second. Give me some time.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah. Can you see it?
Yes.
So it's kind of
Pratushadi, you are lagging.
So I think I'll be skipping some parts. I started by writing. Okay. Then I added some. So on top of that, I laid a layer of water, clean water, and then I added some paint. It's just I am using camel watercolor, and I used the crimson red, I guess. I think it is crimson. Huh? And there's another a bit warmer tone of red, which is, I guess, vermilion. No, scarlet flake. Anyway. So I'll be using those two colors only for the base layer, and let's continue then. It will be lagging a bit, please bear with me. So I just put some red in where there were the roses. I wanted my roses here and here. So I don't think you can see the mouse anyway. So I wanted my roses, I put the red where I wanted my roses to be. And then I added some, it's like, it's not a flat color, you can see some parts are darker, some parts are lighter. So I'll be adding the values later on. Let's see. So this is, I obviously paused when and let it dry. So after the layer is completely dry, what I do is I wet the paper again a bit. And it's, I think a bit, it was a bit wet when I started painting again. So this is when I start adding the values. Okay. Yeah. So I'm just adding the darker parts now. So this part was a bit dried, so I did not want any hard edges just yet. So I damped my brush, and then I softened the edges. Okay. Stop me when you don't understand and ask questions. Okay. Yeah, I will just fast forward it a bit, and you can see that. Yeah. So this was the third layer, I guess. Yeah, it was the third layer. And after the second layer was dry, I was again starting to add the values. Now, watercolor takes a lot of patience and a lot of layers. Okay. I'm adding people over here. So it takes a lot of patience, and there are several layers to it. You have to let it dry. You have to know when the page is damp enough for you to begin again, so the paint doesn't get muddy. And I honestly cannot tell you when to do that and when not to do that. You have to do it by practice. You have to gain this experience by practicing a lot, practicing a lot. And I'll play the video and I'll keep talking. The lag is a bit annoying, but yeah. So you can see that I have to keep some parts light because there aren't any definite petals yet, right? And when you're doing watercolor, the white is irrelevant when it comes to making the portion that you want to make white, white. So you have to keep it right there. The whitest part when you're painting with watercolor is the white of your paper, right? You can't go lighter than that. You can't just add white and expect it to be white again, because when you're when you've painted a layer on it, that's it. You can't go back, right? So when doing something like florals, you have to keep that in mind, that there are very little chances of making mistakes, but I obviously made a lot of mistakes there because here.
nobody is without mistakes, and I am not exactly the best person here to make florals, but yeah, I try anyway. So you see, I have been drying my layers a lot. It's lagging, right? Yeah, okay. I have been drying my layers a lot, and then I'm putting more colors in it, and I'm developing a shape which somewhat looks like a rose at the end of this video. So I'll skip the boring part. If you want to keep watching, you can keep watching anyway. But yeah, it is boring and it takes a lot of time, but you have to keep at it because there is no shortcut. There is no shortcut to manage. There honestly isn't any shortcut to paint roses, because as beautiful as a rose is, it has a very complex structure, and that takes a lot of study. I have painted thousands of roses since I started painting, maybe with watercolor. So I'm fast forwarding it a bit. See, it's been like a minute or something, and I'm basically at the same point because I did not get the values the way I wanted. So I had to keep on adding layers and damping it again and then putting my colors in again. Now it's getting a bit darker because this is like the fifth or sixth layer, and I know where I want to put my petals apparently. See, there is a lighter. See? Wait, I'll pause it. You see this part here, it's a bit lighter, right? So I thought I would add a fold of the petal, like a petal folds like this, right? And the light falls upon this part, so it looks lighter than the darker parts where the this is the joint, I guess, where the petal is blooming from, and this part will look very, very dark compared to the outer sides of the petal. And so I'll continue here. Also, excuse me for stammering a bit. I don't do this a lot, so kind of inexperienced. And you see, yeah, so this is kind of where I end this part, because it I had to dry it again to begin with the next flower. The mini player window or a minimized window? Okay. I think that will work a bit. Okay. Thank you, Riddhi. So I will share my screen again. And I'll show you the second part of it. Yeah. You can see the screen, right?
Yes.
So I'm starting it again. The lag is kind of gone, right? No, it's still there, but anyway, I'll just minimize the window a bit then. Yeah. So I'll talk about it a bit. You see, I have added a lot more layers than there were before. And I have added some leaves as well while I was drying my paint back then. And I did not record it because, yeah, there were a lot of mistakes and all. And honestly, there are no rules where you can add leaves or not. But if you're taking a reference, I did not take any reference for this picture. So if you're taking any reference, just concentrate on where the leaves are and where you want them. That is exactly what it is. You just decide in your head, as Onubrata has already said. So I have a basic structure of the rose, as you can see. this is the center, and then we have spiraling circles going outward. Okay. And we have a leaf here and there, and then there's this bit which is a bit detailed, and yeah, let's run it. So see what I did there. This was a lighter part, and then I added some darker values around it, right? Darker colors around it. This is a way to make things lighter in watercolor. What you do is, you can't make this any lighter, right? You can't put any more paint on it to make this lighter, because that doesn't happen in watercolor. You can't just add white and make it lighter. So what you do is, you paint around it and you make this part darker, so that this looks relatively lighter and your eye falls on it, right? See, I'm painting another petal and applying the same technique over here as well. Now it's started to take some shape that you can call a rose. And this is basically just painting around, adding leaves and improvising my values. This is how it looked like after I was done with that layer. You see, I have added a lot of blue in the process. And since the base layer was red, I thought I would do some darker values in purple so that the red will pop out like this, right? So this part, this bit, I damped it again and I applied a very lighter shade of purple. I mixed obviously Prussian or cobalt blue with the crimson that comes with the Campbell Artist set. And then also I added some values to the leaves. See, it was just a shape, it was just a blob of paint, but then I took a darker green. I just made the green darker by adding some green, adding some black to it and blue. And then these shapes, this is nothing. These are just brush strokes there. Okay. So now I'm painting a petal kind of. See, I'm adding some green over there. The stem. Okay. So notice one thing, there are soft edges and there are hard edges, right? When you have your paper damped, you can't achieve this hard edge. See, this is very sharp. This stem is very sharp. It's just a single stroke and it's very sharp. Okay. I have so many questions, I guess. Oh no. Okay. Yeah. And these parts, they have very soft edges. So by making a hard edge, it's lagging again. Anyway, I just explained right now a bit not long ago that to achieve this kind of hard edge, I just painted around the lighter part. And that you do when the paper is completely dry. And now this part wasn't exactly as dry as you can see. I have a bit of hard edge over there, and then the color is fading away in the background. That means that paper was damp over here. So that is what you need to control. That is what you want to control when you're doing watercolor. And this comes with a lot of practice. Don't get frightened if you suddenly get a hard edge where you wanted a soft edge. You can just damp your brush in water and then paint around it. I will show it in another video as well, that I did it with a cloud painting. And now let's see. I'm just painting another leaf here. You see, I had a hard edge there. Then I damped my brush and I painted around it and it's now softer, right? So that is how you get this base color, this light. And then you can paint on it with a darker shade and you add your details like the veins in a leaf and all. Yeah, see? I just mixed some green with a bit of black and blue and then I painted these veins. And it doesn't have to be exact or definite. It just has to look good to your eye. What you prefer matters the most. And I'm painting some leaves in between these two roses because I thought this part, this... Okay, move your hand. Sorry. Yeah, I thought this part was looking a bit... I don't know, empty and light. I mean, it needed a bit more dimension and values to it, a bit more darker. I wanted it a bit more darker, I guess. So that's why I started adding some leaves over here, although I did not plan to add it when I started painting it at first. But that is the thing. That is, a painting is a journey that you take and you make decisions on your way. Anubrata just explained beautifully what it means and what it is for him. And since I am not talking about sketching, I'm talking about painting. I have to move fast and make decisions pretty quickly because the page is drying and I can't afford to lose a lot of soft touches that I had already achieved and I have to work with them. So that is the point here. In order to paint proficiently with watercolor, you have to practice a lot. You have to make decisions very quickly. And that took me years of practice. Okay, I am not talking about months. It's difficult. It's quite difficult. But then it's nothing. It's not impossible. Okay, anybody can do this. If I can do this, anybody can do this. I've been out of practice for months now, but then I picked up my paint and my brush just a few days ago because this workshop was coming up and I painted this, whatever it is. So I'm fast forwarding it. Yeah, see, there is a leaf there, not a leaf yet. It's a shape, it's a green shape, a blob, where my leaf is going to be. And then I painted around it to make this part of the rose a bit darker, right? Because if the shadow is over here and there is a lot of things going on, then obviously this part won't be as light because the light won't reach it as much as it was doing before when the leaf was not there. So this is something you learn while painting, the light and shadows, what light does to your rose and which part gets light and how it interacts with the darker parts. So just because I added the leaves over there, I had to make the area around it darker because the shadows of the leaves will fall on it. And I wanted these centers of the roses to be a bit more dark, obviously. Because I wouldn't have probably done it if I was just doing it personally. But for the camera, it looked a bit blunt and very flat. Not as vibrant as I wanted it to look on camera. So I had to add more darker values to it. Gets really dark so that the shape just enhances, right? Yeah. Forward it a bit. It's just adding values now. You see, I'm painting around this part because I want this part to be light. And really popping out. And then I add the leaves, the details over there. Then some small details where I think it could use a bit more volume and a bit more chaos, maybe. And then this rose is much darker than this rose because I started it with a warm tone and I started it with a fuller tone of red. So I went on to add some really, really dark parts in it, which I will probably be softening later on. I hope I did. I think I did. In this video, I mean. Yeah. So this is where I left off. This is where I left the video. And then I added some other details with a white pen, I guess, white gel pen. And it kind of looked presentable. I will show it to you in a video. I mean, I will show it to you live. So this is where I end the video. Okay. And yeah. So that was the florals, and I have logged in from my phone as well, and I want to show you the end results of the florals that is in my hands right now. And let me know if you can see it. I will, yeah, just pin the other account that I have there. See, I added some little details. Can you see it? Please respond if you can.
Yes, it's visible.
So, you see, I have added some details with the white pen over here and then on the leaves as well. And I added a bit of background as well because I thought the background, by the time it dried, that is another thing with watercolor that you cannot really tell how a paint will dry. And depending on the amount of water that you've mixed in it, it will dry differently each time, which is very annoying. But then it's a process of learning as well. So I added a bit of dry brush strokes over here. I don't know if you can see it. Okay. I just damped my brush with a lot of paint, not a lot of water, just paint, and just rubbed it around like that. So I got these zigzag patterns at the background, which I think looks cool anyway. So I will stop sharing this video right now. And do we have any questions regarding this? If not, then I will move on to another video that I have made. Shauni, please let me know if there are any questions. Meanwhile,
there are no questions as of yet.
Okay, then I will just share another screen and show you a process of painting mountains. And I'm sorry, I am having to rush through this because, yeah. Can you see it? Yeah.
Yes.
Sorry, it's in portrait mode because I thought my phone was in landscape and then it all recorded in portrait. It's very tiny, I guess. So you can just zoom in. Okay, you pinch and zoom in the video and it will look bigger on your screen. Phone or whatever. Yeah. And this is also lagging. The thing with Zoom, I don't know why it keeps lagging. Whenever I'm sharing a video, it's just lagging. Okay. So let me just talk a bit about this painting. And if you zoom in, pinch and zoom in, you'll see there is a rough drawing of a mountain that I made. And it's not very clear, and I did not even want it to be clear because, yeah, let's not establish any definite values yet. So then I left the mountain part alone. I did not want it to be damp, and I did not want the colors of the skies to bleed into the mountain for obvious reasons. So I just painted around it. I just dampened the paper that was around the cloud, around the mountain, and I started painting my sky. Now for the sky, I used way too many different colors, like yellow, red, blue. I mixed blue and red and made it into a purple, obviously. And then I used some muted sunset colors. Sky turns out to be really purple at the end of the video. Not too purple, but you see, I just added some red over there. And I'm skipping the video because it takes a lot of time and I have to save a lot of time. Okay. Obviously, skip the parts where it was drying, but still, it takes a lot of time to achieve whatever came out as a result. You see, I added some red over here. And some blue over here, and then I'm adding a bit of blue underneath. And this is the first layer of the sky. Okay, there are other two or three layers, I guess. Let's see. And there are no definite ways in which you can paint a sky like this. You just have to go with the flow. You have to listen to yourself, what you want for your sky, how you want to make it look like. But then you have to be aware of the repercussions, okay? Because according to the color of the sky, the snow from the mountain will be reflecting the same color, okay? Because if I am making the sky a bit purple, I'll fast forward it. Yeah. You see? So this is where I ended the first layer of the sky. You see the upper part is yellow. There is a bit of red, and then there's a lot of purple going on over here. And then what I did was I let the sky dry, and while it was completely dry, I wet my mountain a bit, and then I added a very thin layer of yellow on it. Why, I will be explaining later. And this is me adding the yellow. You can see the yellow tone, right? It's not as white. So my target, my purpose here is not to keep the white of the paper at all. I don't want it there for certain reasons. That is, the mountain is a snowy peak, okay? And the sky is a purple, bluish purple kind of a shade. And if you delve a bit deep into the color theory, you don't have to delve that deep, actually. It's a very well-known fact that yellow and blue are complementary colors. Okay, so that is elementary science, why the sky looks blue and whatever that is. So since yellow and blue, they complement each other, I am going to be using a lot of blue and purple in this painting. So the white will pop out if I have a little yellowish tone underneath the paper instead of the white of the paper itself, which would make it look a bit more bluish. That I don't want, okay? Like a lighter shade of the purple that I will already be using. So I don't want that. I want the paper to be white and to make it look white. So that is a part of realism that I will, it's not exactly realism, but an illusion of realism. So let's continue. If you don't understand this part, just drop it in the comment section and I will be explaining. So this is my second layer of the sky, and I'm adding another coat of water, keeping the mountain alone. I let it dry first, okay? So that is the part I skipped. I applied the yellow on the mountains and I let it dry. Then after it was completely dry, I had to paint the sky. So like there's a lot of drying involved, which I skipped obviously because I need to save time. So you have to, you see how patient you have to be when dealing with watercolor, right? And this is where I'm adding a bit of dark. I want another mountain over here, which I'll be adding later on. I did not decide it yet. So I made this portion very purple again. I'm sorry about the light because I had nothing else to do. It will be reflecting from the page and I cannot do anything about it because it has to be very in order for you to see it.
Pratishadi, we have two questions in the chat box.
Please read it out for me.
The first question goes by Arunima Gupta. I am not so much experienced in watercolor painting and I learned by myself. So I wanted to know if there is any particular paper to use for this watercolor painting. Because when I try to layer the painting, the normal kind of paper gets tampered after one or two layers. Please let me know.
Okay. What is the kind of tape that? Okay. So I will be talking about materials. And yeah, it's best that I say it right now. When you're dealing with watercolor and you know that you have to use a lot of layers, go for a very thick watercolor paper. Okay. So there are several brands available like Archie's, Brastro. I think there are Camel watercolor papers as well. Anyway, so there are several brands online as well. Go for the thick ones like 250 to 300 GSM. I hope you guys know what GSM means. It's the unit for thickness of the paper. So go for the thick papers because in watercolor, you have to use a lot of layers. Obviously, if you're trying to achieve a painting that looks presentable and all. And even if you're starting with watercolor, I will suggest that do not use bad papers. Actually, I'm being a hypocrite because I'm using a very bad quality paper over here. And it is not really evident. I think it is evident anyway. But it is a very thin paper. That is why it is, you can see it's like waving a lot because it's soaking up a lot of water. And then the water, it keeps pooling over everywhere. Okay, when you're using a thin paper and you're adding a lot of water in it, layers of water, two things that can happen. One is that the water will start coming off as you apply the brush, like that is relatable. Whenever you're starting off with watercolor, that is the most relatable thing that happens. Brush ghoshti, but paper uthe chole asche, guro guro hoye. That is very annoying, and you have to discard the painting completely. So that is how you learn to control your brush. Don't make it very harsh. I will be talking about brushes and the kind of brands that you can use. And so I would suggest go for any kind of hot pressed papers are good as well. But go for very thick 300 GSM, 250 to 300 GSM papers that are available online or even in your local store. Just go and ask for the thickest paper they have. And when you cut it in a size this small, it's A5, I guess, it won't bend like that. Okay. It's far away, the material that I have. Anyway, so it won't be rolling over like that. It will lay flat on your surface. And that is a good sign when you're doing watercolor because you don't want paint running from all over your paper and into the center of your paper and pooling over there. Then you have to lift up a lot of paint with a cloth. And that is an important point that I forgot to mention. When you're working with watercolor, always keep a cloth handy. Like I have rags like this and tissues. So in order to lift up paint and pooling water, that is water that is pooling on your painting, right? It happens a lot with me and I lift up a lot of paint. It used to happen a lot more, but then I started to control. It's a thing you learn. You see how little amount of water I'm using in this paint so that it doesn't feather out as much and I get the lines correct, right? And also it depends on the paint as well, the brand of paint you're using. And so this is just me adding layers and layers of sky until I'm satisfied. This is the interesting part. So the sky is kind of done and I'm just adding some vibrant colors. And now I think the sky was kind of dry. I started to paint the mountain. Okay. So you see, I'm using a purple. So these are the parts. This is where my shadowy part is. And this is where I'm going to make the light reflect. So even for the shadows, what happens is that the color of the sky will reflect from the shadows and from the snow of the mountain. So the darkest part of the mountain will look the shade of the sky. Okay, so the darkest shade of the sky is purple over here. It's not yellow. That is the warmer tone. And shadows will be cooler in tone, and the values, the lighter values, they will be warmer in tone, right? Where the sun reflects, it looks a bit yellow, right? So that is a warm color. Now, this is a very cool shade of purple that I'm using. And I'm kind of adding some details here and there so that it doesn't look flat. It's just the snow where the shadow lies. That is where my reference was. I sketched out the division where I wanted my shadow to end and my light to begin quite drastically. This is the first layer I added, and I will be adding a second layer. Yeah, I added a second layer. See, it's much darker now, right? This is the crooked part, the mountain. Obviously, you can do whatever you want with your mountain. I just thought it will look cool if I extended this part a bit and then added some random shapes. It's just random details. It's nothing definite. The reference I was using, it's a tutorial on YouTube as well. And I was following that by basically. So yeah, because I had never painted mountains before. Kind of this kind of mountain I had never painted before, and I thought I would try out. And this is me following a YouTube tutorial. Basically, you see, I added another layer there. I did not record it because annoying. This is lighter, and this is, yeah, now it's a bit darker because I did not like the way it dried. It became much lighter, and I wanted it to be a bit more darker. This part, especially the peak. And this part where the most distant part from the sun, because if my light is coming from there, it will be the most distant part. So now I'm just adding details over details. This edge, I will be improvising this edge by the end, because I did not like the way it turned out right now, and I will be changing it later on. This is, I'm just adding this some strokes. I'm just using one brush, you can see, and I will be using probably another brush later on. Yeah. So what I was doing now is that I picked up a bit of blue, right? A little bit of blue I picked up on my thin brush, mixed it with the purple, and that turned out to be a cool shade of the purple that I was already using. A much cooler shade. Then I'm using some random, then I'm drawing some random lines, random brush strokes. So this is the way to make the mountaintop look smooth. So that is the smooth edge of the mountain, and I will be painting some rough rocks as well. Not literally rocks, but some rough dots I will be just putting here and there with a much darker paint. And you see, this is where the edge of the mountain lies. This is a very smooth edge where the snow falls. And yeah, these are just details that I added later on. You can make it as dark as you want, because yeah, it's your painting, and it depends on you how much dark you want it. So, yeah, this is where it begins, I guess. Excuse me a bit. Yeah, sorry about that. And yeah, this is where I started painting the, excuse me. Bhaktusha,
I have to ask you a question.
Yes, ma'am.
বলছি তুই যে দিদিটা সাদা বরফ রাখলি মানে ডান দিকটা ওর উপরটা কোনো আউটলাইন দেওয়া হয় না মানে একদম একদম সাদাই রাখবি
না 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 ওটা আমি শেড করব এই জাস্ট একটু পরে আমি এই দিকটা বুঝিয়ে নিলে ওই দিকটা যে দিকটা লাইট কি ওই দিকটাতেও তো শ্যাডোস থাকবে বিকজ লাইটের শ্যাডো গুলোও পড়বে
আচ্ছা আচ্ছা
ওকে দ্য পেইন্টিং অ্যাকচুয়ালি কামস ইন থ্রি পার্টস আমি স্কাইটা করব ডার্কার পার্ট অফ দ্য মাউন্টেন এন্ড দ্য লাইটার পার্ট অফ দ্য মাউন্টেন এন্ড দেন আইল ফিনিশ ইট অফ
Achha.
So this is where I'm doing the hard rocks. You can see, I just made the paint a bit more thicker by adding some black and red to it, and then I'm adding some hard edges. To pichane kala bista para jabe. Yeah. You see, I just added a hard edge over there, darker shade of the purple I was using, and now it looks like a rocky mountain already. And then just some details, some lines over there, here and there. And it doesn't have any rule where you can do it and where you cannot. It totally depends upon you. And yeah, this is just adding some more lines over the top. Wherever you want the hard edge of your mountain to be or the smooth edge of your mountain to be, you can add it over there. There isn't a definite rule because this is not like I referenced it from a real picture or anything. I just followed a tutorial that was not following a definite tutorial and I made my version of it, right? And that is what it is about, making decisions like right there. There are some hard edges that I added, some shadows I wanted to add over here because it was like looking flat. And I think we are done with this part and now we will move on to the lighter part of the mountain. And I mixed a pinkish purple for this part. And I think I added a bit of yellow as well to make it look warm. So it's basically a warmer tone of the purple I was using. And here as well, since the mountain is a rocky one and it's not like a smooth coat of snow is on top of it at such a height. So you can add some curved lines and some random shapes. You see, it's just random shapes and curved lines where I want my folds to be, folds of the mountains. And it's taking a shape right now. And then when I'm done with this first layer, when I have established my values, where I want my curves and all, then I went back in with the darker, the same kind of purple, but a bit darker, like there's more paint and less water on my brush. And then I'm just highlighting the values, highlighting the shadow parts. See? Just adding a bit more dimension to the already existing curves. So I have a value scale, a range of tones, not just some flat white and then some hard edges of purple, light purple it is, right? And I mixed a bit of red, I guess, yeah, bit more red, and then I went back in with the brush and just added some darker shades where I wanted some curves and like some craters maybe on the snow, and I left some part white. It's not exactly white as I told you, it's basically yellow. It's a very light thin layer of yellow, and since I added a lot of blue over here, it looks whiter than it would have looked if I kept the white of the page intact, which is why I did the yellow wash in the beginning. And then I'm smoothing out this part where there are some hard edges where I don't want them. And you can keep the hard edges if you want. And now what I'm doing is this dry brushing, which is a very interesting technique. You just dip your brush in a paint and wipe it off in a tissue. And then whatever is left of that paint in your brush, you just stroke it on the painting so that all the tones you have used so far like the warm of the white part, this purple, this white, this light purple that I've used, I have dry brushed some of it in this area and this area so that it doesn't pop out as much and doesn't look very drastic and like not entirely a part of the painting or something. So just to keep a balance between the things. Now it's just adding details. I just wanted this part here. I wanted another mountain for some reason because it looked flat, just one mountain over there. So I wanted another mountain over there. Obviously, I did not make it as distinct as this one because my main focus is this mountain. And I mixed a bit of red and purple and whatever was left in my palette after I was done with this painting. And then I added some values to it, I guess. It's not very important that you add a lot of values to it, but yeah, do not neglect this as well. See, some cool tones to add some shadows and all. And I am moving it a bit. You see? Yeah. So this is how the painting looked when I was done with it, kind of. Yeah, not much different. There I wanted this edge to be a bit harsh, the white edge. So I started adding a bit more dark purple over here. So it stands out and you can see. See how it dried, the paint, how it dried. It's not as dark as it was before. So that is the frustrating thing about watercolor. You can never know how it will dry out to be. And yeah, so this is the mountain. And if you have any questions, you can just ask me. Right. I will stop sharing the screen for this one.
There is another question in the chat box. What is the kind of tape that we can use to keep the borders white?
Yeah, so there are washi tapes available. Is it possible to make good quality painting easily available? Yeah, it is. It is. So first I will go to the tape bit. The tape I used is basically cello tape because I did not have washi tapes. I did not have time to buy it. And I ran out of the washi tapes I used. How to blend colors. Okay, I will show it to you. So that is the tape I used. I used basic cello tape over there. And you can always use the washi tape that are available there. It's professional painting tapes. And it won't come out as rough as the cello tape comes out. And it's available online or maybe if you have a good stationery shop near your place, you can go. But the lockdown started, so you can't really. And what is another? Is possible to make a good quality painting with watercolor tubes easily available? Yeah. Whatever I just made right now, I made it with this thing I have. This is Artist's Watercolor by Camel. So I won't suggest you buy the student watercolor that is available by Camel. That is very, the texture is very grainy and it doesn't look as vibrant once it's dried. And it's very frustrating to work with and I stopped using it after a bit. But if you're comfortable with it, you can always use it. And whatever materials I'm using, it's completely locally sourced. It's nothing fancy. Although there are some brushes that I want to show you guys. I don't know if you can get hold of them and I'll start a video over there. Okay, not a good idea. Anyway, so I will show you it right now. So this is a brush that I sourced locally. It's a rodent hair brush, okay? And usually if you go to buy watercolor brushes, they will give you this these brushes with black hair on top of it, which is a good material as well. So I have been using since, I don't know, childhood, plus 5 or 6, I don't know. So I stuck with it because I have a good grip of how it works and what to do with it and what not to do with it. So this is from a local stationery shop. I don't think you will find rodent hair brushes in Kolkata because they're basically illegal. You can't kill a rodent and make brushes. So these are very old brushes that I bought. So these, I don't think these are available anymore. But there are other brushes like this one. I will use a thicker one. Yeah. This I bought on Amazon. And this is not bad actually for watercolor. It's a synthetic brush. And there are several other brands of synthetic brushes available. I can suggest some. Oh, yeah. Anubrata is there. He can suggest some brushes. He has a lot of experience with materials and all. So, Anubrata, please go on and suggest.
Yeah, can you all hear me?
Yeah.
Yeah, so yes. If you're starting out with watercolors, even, you know, I'm in a beginner stage or something. Pratisha has seen some of my drawings. So what I try to, you know, I have used, obviously, the brushes that Pratisha has used. The one that I stumbled upon was, the one that I stumbled upon was Dale Rowney or Dale Rowney. I don't know how the pronunciation is, but it's probably Dale Rowney. It has a set of, you know, 5 brushes, I guess. I can't show it to you now, but it's synthetic brushes and it holds the water. It's just perfect. Like, I have used a lot of brushes, but the, you know, content of this one is just fabulous. Plus, if you're trying to use watercolor brushes and, you know, trying to blend colors, I would suggest to know what kind of brush to use when. It's important as well. If you're trying to, you know, put flat layers of color, you know, big flat layers of color, use big flat brush. If you're trying to blend, use a filbert brush. If you're trying to detail, use a round tip with a, you know, round sharp tip brush. So these are like 3 kinds of brush that I use for, you know, every kind of my watercolor drawings. It's in a beginner level. If you want more details, there are other types of brushes as well. But if you're starting out, these 3 brushes are absolutely all you need for any kind of drawing.
Then, that many amount of brushes, I have just 3 or 4 brushes laid out in front of me. It has a round tip, bigger round tip, and really thin round tip brush. And then I use this really flat. Why can't I find it? Anyway, I can't find anything when I have to. So it's, you saw me painting with it when I was layering the water. It's a very broad kind of thin flat brush. Just good for layering and laying out.
Yes. Yeah.
Really. As well as the brushes, both brushes. This is, I really like watercolor. I used to use, but better. So I used to use watercolor brushes for my acrylic paintings, and which was not a good idea at all because watercolor brushes do not have that kind of hard and stiff bristles that is needed for acrylic painting, right? Because when you're painting with acrylics, you need the paint to flow very smoothly. Even if you're using medium, to do it with watercolor brushes, it is very difficult. It's not impossible right now like that. If you want, I can demonstrate a acrylic painting right now live. I have the materials laid in front of me. So use synthetic brushes, and I think this is which brand? It was called Generic Brushes on Amazon, and it came as a set of 8 or 7 brushes, and it's really, really good. And I really like the bristles that it has. It holds the shape perfectly, and it doesn't feather out like the watercolor brushes would do. And you really need that fine tip when you're doing detailings with acrylics, right? So that is that with brushes. About tapes, I told you, order it from Amazon. Don't go out right now. There are plenty of washi tapes available for bullet journal and everything. It's a wide range of variety available on Amazon. And paper, I told you, use the 300 GSM, either Brustro watercolor papers, Camel watercolor papers, Archies, whatever is over out there. Archies is a bit blotchy, I guess. I remember using it once or twice. And when I was laying my layers out and I was trying to smoothen out the edges a bit, it didn't work as well. I did not like the way it turned out when I was doing Cloudsy as an Ubuntu.
Yeah, so regarding watercolor papers, you know, you already told about the GSM of the paper. That's like 250 to 300. That's ideal for watercolor. And if you, there are three types of watercolor papers. Okay. If you are going for the brand, you know, in Amazon, you get all the three kinds. That is hot pressed, cold pressed, and rough pressed. So it's important to know what to use, when to use, and it's a, you know, option of favoritism as well. I like personally cold press because cold press is smooth to work on. Hot press is a bit rough, and you know, the rough press is just like mountains on the paper and you can't really work on it. It's
texture on it. It's like a canvas paper. I have a canvas sheet right in front of me. I don't know if you can see the texture over here. It's very rough. You can just, you know, move your hands around it and it will feel like a mountain on it. So while doing watercolor, and it depends on the landscape that you want to lay out. If you want to do a rose kind of a painting, you need probably a bit smoother kind of a surface. When you're doing mountains, probably you will, you know, to make that rocks really stand out, you need that hot press kind of paper so that you can show the, when you're dry brushing, you can show the texture of the paper on it. And about clouds as well, hot press is really, really works really nice when painting clouds, I guess, because, you know, feathers out really well, I think. And what are the other questions that you have?
There are two other questions. That is, which brushes are good for acrylic painting? And will the watercolor painting be more attractive if we wet the paper before coloring or just applying the colors on dry sheet?
So it depends upon what kind of painting you're trying to achieve your purpose. Because if you want a really sharp edge, you don't dry your paper beforehand, obviously. And if you want a layer of gradient on your paper, then you have to wet the entire paper and then you have to add your gradient. Anubhuti, you have something to say, right?
Yeah, so obviously that's the application of watercolor. You need to know where you're applying. But since we have limited time, you can obviously search two topics, that is wet on wet and dry and wet on dry. These are the two techniques that, you know, all you need kind of for as a beginner or as a professional. There are literally two kinds of things. When you're doing only watercolors, either you can wash out the paper and then put colors on it, the colors will spread, and that is wet on wet. And if you don't want the colors to spread, if you want to control it more, then you go with colors directly on the dry paper. So that
you froze again. Okay, so what he said was the two techniques that I also used while painting my roses and my mountains, that is wet on wet and wet on dry. And for the wet on wet, I showed you the gradients first, right? So I completely damp my paper and then I load my paint on it. That is wet on wet. I have my paper wet and then I all dump the wet paper on it. I wet paint on it. And then there is the dry on wet on dry technique that is I used for the mountains when I was doing the lighter part of the mountain. I did not have my paper already damped, right?
So I could achieve that rocky hard edge that was there in between the shadow and the lighter part of the mountain. So it completely depends on the kind of painting you're opting for. So I think that are the two techniques. There's another technique that is paint lifting. And I usually do it when I make a mistake. And it is very difficult to do if you are not using the right kind of paper and the right kind of dampness in your paper. It becomes very difficult to lift the paint. And I completely avoid doing that. And I just go on with the painting and I see how it turns out, because I do not want to lift the paint, because most of the time what I do is I tamper with my page too much and it comes off, like the paper completely crumbles like that. And so that isn't a smart choice for me when I'm using low quality paper or something. But whatever material that is available in Indian market, your technique completely depends on the kind of material that you're using, especially when you're using watercolor, because you have to keep switching your materials and you have to keep looking for the things that work for you when you're doing a painting. And it is a smart way to begin with simple gradients, simple landscapes, right? Simple clouds, then to go into difficult kind of paintings. And I have a cloud painting and I have some paintings with me that I really want to share with you guys. I just recently did those. I'm sharing my screen again. And yeah. Thank you, ma'am, so much.
I guess there is another question. No, not yet.
এই অনুব্রত কে একটা প্রশ্ন করছি, যদিও আকার সঙ্গে যুক্ত নয়, তুমি যে লিখছিলে না বোর্ডের উপর কিছু ওয়ার্ড লিখলে, পারপাস এই ওয়ার্ডটা লিখলে, তুমি কি ইউজ করছো, মাউস ইউজ করছো ল্যাপটপের সঙ্গে নাকি আঙুল দিয়ে করছো?
আমি এটার ব্যাপারে বলতাম কিন্তু টাইম খুলানো না। সো ডিজিটাল আর্টের ব্যাপারে যদি কিছু বলতে চাই, ফার্স্ট অফ অল এটা মাউস না, ইটস আ ড্রয়িং প্যাড। ওকে, দিস ইজ আ ড্রয়িং প্যাড, দিস ইজ হোয়াট আই ডিড উইথ ইউ নো অল দ্য লাইন্স এন্ড এভরিথিং অন দ্য স্ক্রিন, এই জিনিসটারই। ওকে, দিস কামস লাইক দিস। ওকে, ইটস ওয়ান অফ দ্য চিপেস্ট ওয়ান্স, এটার থেকে কম দামে বোধহয় তেমন ভাবে ড্রয়িং প্যাড নেই। অ্যান্ড এটার উপরে বেসিক্যালি কি, this is what you have to get used to digital art korar jonno and when you are doing something on a screen like this,
so stylus use korcho
eta hocche eta oi pad tar shongei ashe, it's a sensor pad ar etar upore just likhte lage ota.
Acha,
again there are many reviews internet e paowa jay, details e bola jay etar byapare, because digital art er jonno eta crucial.
কারণ আমরা এখন তো ক্লাস নেই, আমরা এটা ফেস করি, মানে ধরো আমি যদি বোর্ড ওয়ার্ক করতে চাইবো তো আমি মাউস দিয়ে বা এ দিয়ে লিখতে পারি না, আমার মানে এখানে জ্যাম বোর্ড থাকে গুগল মিটে বা কিছুতে ও লেখা যায় না, আমি ওটাই জিজ্ঞাসা
করবো। এখন এখন অনেক ধরনের এই ড্রয়িং প্যাড বেরিয়ে গেছে যেটা মোবাইলের সঙ্গে কানেক্ট করে ইউজ করা যায়, অ্যান্ড মেনি কোম্পানিজ ইউজ ইট। ইফ ইউ ওয়ান্ট আ চিপ ওয়ান, এক্সপি পেন ইজ you know a cheaper models, or there are many erokom just laptop er moddhe stylus use korar jonno like a drawing pad, but otar moddhe kono pressure sensitivity nei, kichu nei, like it's not ideal for drawing but only for writing erokom o pad paoa jay, to teachers can use those are really good for teachers, especially ekhon jokhon online class cholche.
Okay, thank you for this.
Yes ma'am, sure ma'am.
Pratushadi, তোমার জন্য আরেকটা question আছে, and that's any other colors that we can use on canvas, as in which other companies are good as far as acrylic colors are concerned, because sometimes certain shades aren't available.
Oh, yes, okay. So you buy I haven't seen available in Canada. I will just stop sharing for now. But you can also go with Duxford. I recently started using them and I love how smooth they are. And it I use this palette. Okay. So this has it doubles the shades when you are going for a much more expensive palette. I think it has 12 colors or something, and the bigger set comes in 24 shades, which is nice to go by with, you know, for beginners as well. And the color is very smooth. It lays nicely on the canvas, and if you're using the right kind of brushes that I just talked about, it really helps a lot. And Camel is okay. Camel is cheap and all, but Camel doesn't come in a lot of shades. I think Anubrata will agree, but he hates acrylics. He absolutely hates acrylics. So yeah, I can't hear you, Anubrata, because sometimes certain shades are
inherent. I hate Camel. It's unimaginably bad. So bad.
Problem with acrylics is that dye is almost cracked, so you have to take it out on the palette, and you have to be really fast and you have to be really prompt. You have to keep mixing a lot of medium, and it gets very hectic when you're doing acrylics. And I would have demonstrated, but there is a time crunch, as we know. So I'm just taking questions and explaining stuff right now. And there is another thing I wanted to address, is that if you're watching YouTube tutorials to practice watercolor, please do so, because I have seen really amazing tutorials on YouTube. I was not a fan of it some like years back. YouTube dekhe shikbo ami jokhon nije eto din dhore watercolor shikhe eschi, but yeah, that's a myth. Don't go for it. Whatever you see online, you just I just take reference from real pictures and I start recreating them until I am satisfied or I am not. But then I learn 1,000 ways in which I will not be doing the same picture again, which is important. And until and unless I figure out the right way to do it from gouache, I have not used it yet. I ordered some, but then the lockdown thing happened and I did not receive the parcel yet. I would have used gouache back then, but then I have not used it yet. I think it's going to be difficult for me. I kind of do not like the kind of texture that gouache and poster color has. I have a full set of poster colors that are just laying around and I don't use it, because I do not like the texture that is very grainy and it doesn't dry up well. Anubrata has something to say again.
Yeah, so if you like acrylic, or you can do with acrylic, or you have some experience with acrylic, gouache is just in between watercolor and acrylic. Watercolor, if you are putting dry, without the water on paper, it will be very grainy, very textury, dull. It's bad. But gouache has this opaque kind of a texture when you're putting it without water. So it acts like an acrylic, right? And if you mix water with it, it will act as a watercolor. So it's kind of a mix between both. It can do transparency as well as opaque, depending upon the amount of water that you're putting. So yeah, it might be better than acrylic. Anything is better than acrylic.
So that is kind of... Have any more questions about using water in acrylics? I would strongly recommend not using water to thin out your acrylics. Just use acrylic medium. Please do not go for water, because it messes up with the texture so much. And it's not pretty. It's not at all pretty to look at when you're applying water on acrylics and then you apply it on paper or on canvas. It totally messes up with the texture. And I'm not a fan of it. If it works for you, then fine. But I'm not a fan of it. If you're doing it on glass, maybe. I paint bottles as well. So at
some point I thought mixing water with acrylic might work with the glass medium, and it did to some extent, but then the thing chips out after a certain point. So it's not a good binding agent for acrylic at all. If you're using water to thin out acrylics, do not buy acrylic medium like this. This is a nice medium. I ripped off the label, obviously. And Camel has mediums that come in those same bottles as the acrylic paint. Those are nice as well. I buy it in bulk to use with my acrylics. So yeah. And I think also I saw a question in the form that was circulated, and we both wanted to address it, that how to make a perfect painting for beginners or something like that, right? In quickly. Thank you, ma'am. We should wrap it up after we address this issue, right, Anubrata? I think we're kind of done with the discussion right now. Yeah, so there is no easy way to go by, and there is no easy way in which you can produce a painting that looks like professional and will scream professionalism. So you have to practice, you have to put in those hours, you have to mess up thousands of roses before you can get that perfect acrylic rose. To remind that you messed up these many roses, so you can get the rose correct, right? It's super
Yeah.
It doesn't. I can't sketch like. Okay. I won't even go in that topic. Effort to go there, reach that, level or pedestal. But then it's totally worth the effort. And if you're seriously in for it, you will do whatever it takes to go and reach that level. But if you just want to paint for your, to calm your mind and to, for the fun of it, you are welcome to do it. There is nothing wrong with it. You post it, whatever you want to. It's completely up to you.
I'll address this one because it's kind of fun, because I'm very hard on myself. Now what happens is, I like to draw for fun. The drawing won't come out good, and I'll feel bad about myself. That's the majority. Okay. Now what happens is, if you're as I said, the purpose here is very important. If you're drawing for fun, okay, draw something that you can do. That you can do. Don't take up something challenging and expect, hey, I will do something in one go. If you can, obviously you should, but recognition and the purpose comes here, because we are all mature here. I'm not talking to some class 5 kids or class even 8 kids or 10 kids who just started drawing classes. We draw this as a hobby. Pratyusha has done it, and most people in the club has done it many a times. And there isn't any wrong with any approach, but it's all a mind game. If you can, as much as happiness comes with it, there is sadness and depression as well. I won't go to say depression, but there is absolutely sadness with it. So you have to figure out, how do I balance those? As I said, getting those lines correctly is not important, because in the end, real world does not even have lines. Realism does not even have lines. What are you even thinking about? We are thinking about shapes. We are thinking about shadows. We are thinking about light. But obviously, it's not fun when you do all these in one go, right? You have to take one thing at a time, and then tackle it as long as you can, and then go for it with another direction. Take references, draw from your mind, does not really matter. But if you want to have fun, as in like professionals have, they are really having fun while drawing. I see a lot of professionals streaming on YouTube, you might have seen as well, and they are actually having fun. How do they do that? They know, they have, it's just like, I know human anatomy. like I'm not saying I don't know that much, but you know, they know human anatomy. Now it's not like the arm will be just like this. They will just a balloon and put an arm on it. And how do I do that? That's their fun part. It's like, it's very curiosity. There's so much of curiosity going on that you have to constantly use your brain to figure out what do I want to do here? Even if it's for a, you know, reference photo or even drawing from your mind. Recently, I came to know that sketching, the term sketching refers to drawing from your mind, scribbling from your mind. So what I did today with the photo is not actually, a sketch. It's maybe a photo study or a drawing, yeah. But it's not technically a
I think you're back now. Are you? So to continue what he was saying about realism and all, I told you how a mountain looks realistic, and I think I at the moment I if you look closely, it if you really zoom in there and you look closely, you will just see it's random shapes, nothing else. It's just random shapes, some light and shadow, and how it interacts with each other. And if you look it from a distance, it looks like it's popping out of the paper. Right? So that is what realism is for me. It's like not exactly real, but it's an illusion of reality, right? You're lying to people that it's real. It looks real. Oh my God, it appears to be real. So that is what painting is to me. If I'm studying from nature, if I'm studying from a photograph, it's how I am perceiving it and how I want it to turn out, how I would have created it if I were to create that landscape. If I was God and I was creating that landscape, how I would have created it. So that is like twice removed from reality. As we say in literature, I'm a literature student, so I will definitely be using some of the references. So what you see, you create a picture of it in your mind, and what you create is that it's you're transferring that picture that you have in your mind on the paper or on the screen or whatever that you're doing, on the photograph that you're clicking. So
yeah, this is where the skill building comes from. We all imagine various kind of things. Even we can imagine up human faces, but can we draw? We cannot. This is why you have to study. You have to put in those hours and figure out, you know, in a fun way. Not like, okay, how do I do this? This line is not straight. The eyes are not straight. No, we are not doing this. We have to figure out the positions, the proportions, the shapes, and all the interactions there is to it. To the point where you can understand your skill, you can recognize those skills. If I see this picture, I want to turn it into something like that, like I did with the pen drawing. There is obviously no lines on the photo reference itself, but I invented those lines. Why did I invent that? Because I like the style. I know that if the lines are put this way, they will interact in a bigger picture. It's somewhat, you know, semi-realistic manner. So that's where the skill building comes from. That's where photo reference studies come from. So my goal personally is to draw anything that I like from my mind to be able to draw, you know, put forward on a paper. So as long as I'm not being able to do, it's just a process of drawing everything. Can I draw a ship? I can't. Can I draw a building? I can't. Can I draw a certain type of tree, a fig tree? Okay, I can't. So I have to draw that to know that. I have to put in those hours to draw them accurately to know what's going on. And then I can, you know, draw it. So this is where the, you know, proportions come in, the actual, skill comes in. Like you have to build that. If you can't see and draw, you cannot put something on an imagination and expect people to consider that as something that you want to explain. So it's all a mind game, and it is fun. It's more about curiosity rather than just drawing, you know, blending colors and what colors to use and which pencil to use, which medium to use. Although, yes, medium material that you're using is important. It's important for your style. You have to experiment with a lot of them to know what you're comfortable with. But don't just like, I used this for the first time, I did not like, I'm just discarding that. Don't do that. You don't know. You're not well equipped, like mentally, you cannot recognize your skill so much. So try on. Okay, after 10 times, if you don't like, yeah, discard that. So
thank you so much you guys for this amazing session. I'd like to give the vote of thanks to you guys. So creativity takes courage, and although creativity is infinite, our creative workshop has come to its inevitable end. And I would like to end the workshop by first of all thanking our principal ma'am for giving this wonderful opportunity to us. I would also like to thank our teachers in charge, Professor Smita Rai, Professor Devatri Ghosh, and Professor Nivedita Chakraborty for trusting us with the responsibility of this workshop. Last and but not the least, I would also like to thank Dr. Shatrupa Bandhupadhyay, of course, without whom it would have been impossible to host this and organize this. Most importantly, I would like to thank you guys, Pratushadi and Unubrotoda, for conducting this wonderful and creative workshop and helping us with so many innovative ideas. And thank you all the club members for their active interest and participation. Thank you so much. It has been great fun. Thank you.
Thank you, Shauni. কথা একটু লাস্টে বলি, প্রত্যুষার অনুগ্রহ করে।
Yes, of course.
আচ্ছা, তোমাদের আমরা যেটা ভেবেছি যে যারা যারাই আমাদের এখানে স্পিকার হিসেবে আসবেন বা যারা এক্সপার্ট হিসেবে আসবেন, আমরা একটা করে লেটার অফ অ্যাপ্রিসিয়েশন দেব কলেজের তরফ থেকে। তো তোমরা যখন পাবে, তোমরা মেইল আইডিটা নিশ্চয়ই ওদের কাছে তোমাদের আছে, তো যখন পাবে আমি চাইবো তোমরা একটু তোমাদের তরফ থেকে একটু ফিডব্যাক দিও, এই প্রোগ্রামটা তোমাদের মানে করে কেমন লাগলো, ভালো খারাপ যাই লেগে থাকুক।
ওকে ম্যাম।
Club members, please to fill up the form that has been given in the chat box.
Okay. So I think we are done for the day, Shauni.
Yes.
Thank you so much for having us. It's so good to be back, and I'm publicly going to announce how proud I am of you, Shauni, taking up my post and doing a much better work than I would have done.
No, absolutely not. You were a star.
I really miss being in the club, and to everyone that has joined the club after I have left, best of luck. And yeah, you people are doing some great work. I am following your Instagram and whatever social media you have. It's amazing how active the page is now. I think the lockdown has done something good at least.
We are trying
best
to keep the positivity.
All of you.
We are trying to spread the positivity around and all. So, thank you guys. Thank
Which
you so much.
Which is very essential right now in these times. Okay. Bye, people.
Bye.
Thank you.
Anubrata, tata. Bye bye.
Bye.
ওকে রিদ্ধি
হ্যাঁ ম্যাম
তো আমরা কি এবার লিভ করব
হ্যাঁ ম্যাম আপনি ওই ইউটিউবে লাইভটা বন্ধ করে দেবেন
হ্যাঁ আচ্ছা একটা কথা বল দাঁড়া লাইভটা বন্ধ করব আবার কি করে সে ওখানে গিয়ে না দাঁড়া
হ্যাঁ ম্যাম
ওই লাইভ স্ট্রিমিং এইখানটা এন্ড স্ট্রিম করে দাও তো
হ্যাঁ ম্যাম
এন্ড স্ট্রিম হলো কি দেখো এবার